Turkish Airlines Euroleague.
Turkish Airlines. 7 days. And Winline. Official global sponsors in association with the Turkish Airlines Euroleague.
Welcome back to magnificent Istanbul, Turkey, and the crowning moment of the Turkish Airlines Euroleague season, the winner-take-all title game between CSKA Moscow and Olympiacos Piraeus, both ready to rock, sold out Sinan Erdem Arena in a battle to make history tonight as champions of a continent. This date with destiny features super talented CSKA against an Olympiacos team that surprised the experts and maybe even itself by even reaching this Final Four. But in 40 minutes of intense EuroLeague team basketball, anything is possible. So don't lose your seats until we find out which of these great teams will lift the trophy tonight. Hello, I'm Frank Lawler from EuroLeague TV. And as we watch Olympiacos and CSKA arriving earlier to Sinan Erdem Arena, let's bring in our own expert, George Zidek. And George, as a former EuroLeague champion yourself, what can you tell us about this moment in a player's life?
Good evening, Frank. It does not get any better for this as a player. This is the only elite basketball in the world that every year has one game, do or die, to become champion. I think that gives players an emotional charge that cannot be matched as they walk onto that floor tonight.
George, one fascinating aspect of this final is that both head coaches, Dusko Ivkovic of Olympiacos and Jonas Kozlauskas of CSKA, coached the other team earlier in their careers. First time that has happened in a title game, and first, and both, of course, have won this title before.
Yeah, I played for Jonas Kozlauskas in 1999 when he took our Žalgiris team to the EuroLeague title as big underdogs. Now he's going against an Olympiacos team that is very much the surprise of this season. Olympiacos is guided by the Dean of European Coaching, Dusko Ivkovic, who gave the club its only EuroLeague title 15 years ago. That's in 1997.
And don't forget, George, that Kozlauskas defeated Ivkovic and Olympiacos back in the 1999 semifinals in blowout fashion. So these two guys have faced each other on a stage this big before. You were part of that. You saw that Jonas Kozlauskas, who the other night with CSKA knocked out the champions Panathinaikos, certainly has, even though he hasn't been back here since 1999, has done it before.
But both are great coaches. They have a lot of experience. They have teams. Frank, they are arriving at the final game. I am sure that both teams, both coaches and the staffs, they will give it all.
We will hear from tonight's head coaches shortly, but as we watch Olympiacos and CSKA warming up for the final, let's look back at the thrilling victories on Friday that got them here in our semifinals recap presented by Nike.
Their opponents had won 4 of the last 5 EuroLeague titles. But on semifinals Friday at the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague Final Four, the teams with the newest rosters here in Istanbul, CSKA Moscow and Olympiacos, made sure that the trophy will be decided between them this time. And neither had it the least bit easy. In fact, the semifinals were as close as ever. In the first semifinal, CSKA found itself quickly in trouble and trailing by 14 points at the end of one quarter to defending champion Panathinaikos Athens. A second quarter turnaround started at the defensive end with Andrei Kirilenko and Nenad Krstić racking up block after block, changed everything. Before halftime, with young Alexei Zved taking over on offense, CSKA had evened the score and it was a whole new ball game. Victor Griapa's passes started getting his teammates easy baskets, while CSKA's defense frustrated the Panathinaikos pick and roll. Still, CSKA had to overcome the heart of the champions, as Panathinaikos regained a 6-point lead early in the fourth quarter. That's when the superstar trio of Kirilenko, Krstić and Milos Teodosic rallied CSKA into the lead before Zved dueled a legend, Sarunas Jasikevičius, to send the game into a frenzied final minute. A brilliant play saw Teodosic make both an inbounds pass and a go-ahead shot within 2 seconds. CSKA's defense did the rest, assuring that the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague would have a new champion. Then it was the turn of Olympiacos to face the team it lost to in the 2010 final. FC Barcelona Regal had much more height and experience, but the Reds walked on the floor and sent a message by scoring the first 8 points of the game. Then they followed their leader, Vasilis Spanoulis, to consistent control of the scoreboard, although mighty Barcelona stayed right on the heels of Olympiacos. When the EuroLeague's greatest scorer ever, Juan Carlos Navarro, gave Barcelona its first lead, Spanoulis answered within seconds. And on the last play of the half, he assisted Joey Dorsey on a monster slam that gave momentum back to their team. With Vangelis Manzaris starring on defense and Kostas Papanikolaou making big plays, Olympiacos maintained control after halftime. And when key baskets were needed, Georgios Printezis stepped up without hesitation. Barcelona wouldn't go away and came within 2 points of tying in the game's final minute. But Spanoulis was the decider. His step-back three-pointer brought down the house, and his dish to Dorsey completed one of the biggest upsets in years as Olympiacos joined CSKA in Sunday's title game.
Back to Sinan Erdem Arena in Istanbul, and George, after seeing those tough victories that Olympiacos and CSKA pulled out in the semifinals, what do you see as the keys going into tonight's final?
Frank, we've got to start with two born leaders who will be on the court tonight. And I'm talking, of course, about Vasilis Spanoulis of Olympiacos, a former Final Four MVP, and Andrei Kirilenko of CSKA, who was named the EuroLeague's MVP of this season just last night. Two very different players. Kirilenko dominates in the front court as a defensive game changer. He was the season's EuroLeague leader in rebounds and blocks and ranks second in steals. Spanoulis, on the other hand, will have the ball in his hands constantly for Olympiacos. There is nobody better at controlling the tempo of the game while he's scoring and dishing assists just to make his team better.
George, CSKA not only has Kirilenko, but two more players named to the All-EuroLeague team last night, center Nenad Kirstić and point guard Miloš Teodosic, himself a former EuroLeague MVP, as is veteran small forward Ramunas Siskauskas.
There's no doubt that CSKA is absolutely loaded, Frank. Any one or more of those guys could be the difference tonight. We saw Teodosic hit the key shot as CSKA dethroned Panathinaikos on Friday. Perhaps Olympiacos has less star power, but a lot of talented players who understand their roles exactly. The quick inside-outside scoring of Georgios Printezis and the presence of Joey Dorsey, he's a mountain man in the paint, will be very important for Olympiacos against the shot blockers of CSKA tonight.
And of course, George, these teams played twice earlier in the season, with CSKA winning both. What effect do those two games have coming into this one?
We shall see, Frank. But there are two reasons that Olympiacos fans don't need to look back and worry. Dorsey, first of all, had just joined the team when they lost to CSKA and wasn't yet part of the lineup in the first game. And let me remind you, Frank, the second game didn't really affect either team's possibilities of advancing in the competition. And CSKA hit an amazing 11 of 12 three-pointers in the first half to win that one very early. With an Olympiacos team that has gotten better each game, I expect tonight to be a very different story.
And let's not forget the kids, George. There are several under 25-year-olds on both these teams who could prove to become X-Factors tonight.
Well, on CSKA's side, there are two in particular, and that's Alexei Shved, who led CSKA back from 14 points behind in the semifinal on Friday in an electrifying performance. If he repeats that tonight, CSKA will be in very good shape. Watch out for him playing with power forward Andrei Vorontsevic, as they love to come off the bench together and put CSKA even in a higher gear.
Okay, George, and how about the Olympiacos youngsters?
Well, first, that's Kostas Papanikolaou for you, a two-year starter, only at the age of 21. Do you believe that? He is as active as anyone on the court. Number two is Vangelis Mantzaris, who plays great on the ball defense, which will his team will surely need tonight. Kostas Lukas, he completes the new kids on the block for Olympiacos, who did not play much on Friday, but had big plays in the last few months to get Olympiacos closer to the Final Four.
Lucas and Manzares in the backcourt could be even more important for Olympiacos after another point guard, AC Law, was injured on Friday. He is dressed to play, and we'll see how fit to play he is when this game gets started. We've also noticed, as you'll see in the lineup for Olympiacos, we've noticed that Lazaros Papadopoulos, who didn't play on Friday, is also in the lineup. Again, we are waiting for tip-off in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague title game, ready to start in a matter of minutes. We're seeing the players introduced on the floor. They gotta be nervous, George, you know that.
But I said, Frank, before that the worst thing is the semifinal. You are really nervous. You have butterflies in the stomach. You are really jittery. But once you get the semifinal out of the way, I really and honestly think that the final is a lot easier.
As we said, the Turkish Airlines early final four will culminate right here in Istanbul, Turkey at Sinan Erdem Arena. CSKA Moscow against Olympiacos. CSKA going for its seventh title. Olympiacos going for its second title. We shall see. While we wait, we can tell you who tonight's starters will be, beginning with Olympiacos Piraeus. And there we had a look at the starting lineup for Olympiacos Piraeus with Vasilis Spanoulis and Vangelis Matsaris in the backcourt, Marco Kessel on the wing at small forward, Pedro Antic at the power forward spot, and Joey Dorsey holding down the center spot. That's the same lineup they had starting the semifinal, which they controlled very well. So Dusan Ivkovic starting with the same guys he had on Friday night. Let's see who the starters then are for CSKA Moscow.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention please. Miloš Teodosic, number 4, Serbia.
Ramūnas Šiškauskas, number 8, Lithuania.
Viktor Kajapa, number 31, Russia.
Andrew Tierling, number 15, Russia.
Erat Krstić, number 12, Serbia.
And there we saw the starters for CSKA Moscow with Milos Teodosic at the point guard spot, Ramūnas Šiškauskas playing the two guard, Andrei Kirilenko playing small forward, Viktor Kriapa at the power forward, and Nenad Kirstić at the center spot. Mr. So Duda Evkovic, or Jonas Kozlowski is the head coach of CSKA, the same as Duda Evkovic of Olympiacos, sticking with their starters from the semifinals and having seen those starting lineups. Let's now hear from the men who chose them for tonight's Turkish Airlines EuroLeague final with our game analysis presented by Nike.
The Turkish Airlines EuroLeague title game will be colored red tonight as two teams that started the season with very different expectations, CSKA and Olympiacos, battle at Sinan Erdem Arena in Istanbul for the right to be called the continental champion. CSKA dominated the season while winning 17 of its first 18 games, including two comfortable victories over Olympiacos in the top 16. Olympiacos has seen its ambitions rise to the point of upsetting another favorite, Barcelona, in the semifinals. By knocking out Panathinaikos on Friday, CSKA assured that a new EuroLeague champion will be crowned tonight in Istanbul. His CSKA teammates will depend on the leadership of Andrei Kirilenko, who was named this season's MVP on Saturday and was joined on the All-EuroLeague first team by big man Nenad Kirstić. Two more former MVPs, playmaker Milos Teodosic and veteran Ramunas Šiškauskas, return to the title game to lend CSKA valuable experience, while young guns Alexei Zved and Andrei Voronsevich lead the charge off the Moscow bench.
This difference of CSKA, where dominant role is for sure Kirilenko with his rebounding, his fast hands, blocking shots, everything else, and just to try to run the game. And for sure our main problem yesterday was rebound. We lost rebounds, we have to control it if we want to be competitive at that game.
We have to do everything to take the throw, everything.
Olympiacos has its own born leader in Vasilis Spanoulis, a former Final Four MVP and All-Euroleague first-teamer. Spanoulis is surrounded on the perimeter by dynamic young talents like defensive ace Vangelis Manzaris and high-flying Kostas Papanikolaou. Inside, constant scoring threat Georgios Printezis makes his moves knowing that the tandem of Kyle Hines and Joey Dorsey are always ready to attack the rim. Two rosters that depend on strong veterans for leadership and young talents for energy make this unpredictable final matchup a potential thriller.
Day by day we're playing better, and some teams get pressure from beginning, that let's say from beginning media start talk that this team have to win or this team, and we have pressure. Olympiacos on beginning was not between those teams, but what we did is unbelievable. We're playing excellent, and we're playing without pressure.
We are at the moment one real team, you know. It's a real team. Every player knows his own rule, and we have to stay together. It is one big opportunity for us, and we have to do it.
And there we heard from the two head coaches in tonight's Turkish Airlines Euroleague final. There's Duda Ivkovic, and behind him, down the row from him, Jonas Kozlauskas. They faced off in the 1999 semifinals, with Kozlauskas' Žalgiris team defeating Olympiacos and Ivkovic. They are back now for one bigger game, the title game of the Turkish Airlines Euroleague, starting in just a few moments. They will be fighting for the trophy that both of these guys won before. Ivkovic with Olympiacos in 1997, Kozlauskas with Žalgiris in 1999. So both of these men have been here and know what it takes, as do several players on their team. We get a look at the referees for tonight's game: Luigi Lamanic of Italy, Jose Martin of Spain, and Tolga Sahin of Italy. They will be holding the whistles for this very special occasion in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague Final Four title game. We will be followed live around the world on television in 174 countries and elsewhere through internet and social media, and more than 600 accredited journalists in attendance here at the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague 2012 Final Four. The stage is set. It belongs to CSKA Moscow and Olympiacos Piraeus, getting ready to tip off the final. George, final thoughts before we tip off.
Well, I think that both teams are ready, and they just cannot wait for the tip-off to happen, Frank. You really want to get started, get the ball up in the tip-off, and start playing. This is what it's all about. This is a knockout battle, fight for the title. That's it, Frank. 40 minutes or more for the big show.
Here we go. The players are coming on to the court. As we said last night, Andrei Kirilenko, CSKA Moscow, named the MVP of the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague season. Joining him on the first team, Nenad Kirstic, who is also in the starting lineup, and on the second team, Milos Teodosic, a point guard for CSKA. A great season by them, rewarded at the FS EuroLeague Awards ceremony last night. They were joined on the first team by Vasilis Spanoulis of Olympiacos Piraeus.
Frank, if there's any question about fatigue, being tired, I think both coaches said it. Everybody is a little bit tired, but I think it just goes out of the window when the players step on the court. Let's remind our viewers that Teodosic played 32 minutes, Kirilenko 34 minutes for CSKA in the semifinal, whilst Vasilis Spanoulis played 33 minutes for Olympiacos. Those are only three players that got more than 30 minutes on Friday.
We are ready for the start of the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague title game in 40 minutes. If there's no overtime, we will have a champion of the 2011-2012 season. These teams have earned it. Now they have to play one more game to see whether CSKA Moscow or Olympiacos Piraeus of Greece will emerge tonight with a historic victory and the trophy celebration. It should be a great game. Here we go with the tip-off. The final has begun. The rebound controlled by Olympiacos. Vangelis Mantzadis with the ball. Passing off to Pedro Antic and into the hands of Vasilis Spanoulis. He gets free, gets it to Pedro Antic on the wing. Antic drives, a running shot off the backboard to get it started for Olympiacos.
That was a lucky shot by Pedro Antic, but that just showed you how difficult the big guys of Olympiacos gonna have it. He had a really difficult shot over Krstić.
CSKA first possession, Šiškauskas on the wing, Kriapa hands off to Milos Teodosic. Back to Šiškauskas. Six on the shot clock, Šiškauskas drives, stopped on the baseline, turnaround jumper, and that goes in as well. Both teams starting off with good shots.
That was a good play by Šiškauskas because he used patience and he used an advantage over Spanoulis. That is his height.
Mantzadis bringing the ball up for Olympiacos. There's Pedro Antic making his move to the basket, misses, and the rebound tapped out to Milos Teodosic.
And you saw that again, Kirilenko coming from the weak side and just bothering the shot of Pedro Antic.
Teodosic launches from three off the backboard and out into the hands of Pedro Antic.
That was a quick shot by Milos Teodosic.
Wanting to get going, missed the shot. Spanoulis free, gets the ball to Dorsey, but he gives it up to Kirilenko, who's right in the right place at the right time.
That's the best as they get. Defensive stop at Andrei Kirilenko, again with his active hands.
Kirstich in the paint, spins on Dorsey, misses the shot, and Dorsey comes up with the rebound.
That could be the crucial matchup of the game right there on the block, because CSKA's going to like to go to Kirstich down low.
Nice spin move by Kirstich, but he did not get the angle on the shot. Here's Spanoulis going cross court to Mantzadis, and he goes inside to Dorsey, back to Spanoulis, working on Kriapa to Dorsey, misses inside again. Those big CSKA defenders, top shot blocking team in this league, bothering Dorsey in low.
All three shots on the inside bothered by CSKA shot blockers, and a lot of contact there, Frank.
2-2 score after 2 minutes in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague final. CSKA ball, Teodosic makes a move for the basket, misses his layup, and Dorsey has a rebound. Outlets to Mantzadis. He tries to go to Pedro Antic, but the ball is kicked. It will stay Olympiacos' ball.
Frank, do you expect some easy baskets to be scored tonight? I don't think so. Look at the defense. The players are putting on a defensive show so far.
But George, after seeing this, as you said, trouble inside. We saw Olympiacos attack against Barcelona as quick as possible the other night. They may go to that option tonight, get the easiest, quickest shot they can, and there's Vasilis Spanoulis drawing the first foul on Ramunas Šiškauskas.
Well, Frank, I think they are trying, but just the CSKA defenders are everywhere. They are doing a really good job with the defense on perimeter. On the inside, they have such long players.
I know Antic got to the hoop once, but the defense made it before him. Here's Marco Kessel trying to get a shot off. The ball lands inside to Pedro Antic and knocked out of bounds by Teodosic. Nothing easy so far, and I don't think anybody can expect it the rest of the night.
Nothing, absolutely nothing easy. There is ball, everybody's attacking it.
Spanoulis will inbounds for Olympiacos to Dorsey. Gets the ball, goes inside. This is to Kessel for a three-point try, that's off the mark. CSKA controls the board.
Frank, I think if Jonas Kozlauskas called for great defense from the get-go, I think he got his wish granted, because CSKA is very, very focused defensively.
Kriapa out top, tries to throw the ball over to Šiškauskas, but on the pass, he was pushed down below by Pedro Antic.
But look at that, Frank. Pedro Antic is pressuring the ball in Viktor Kriapa's hands, 9 meters from the basket.
That's because Kriapa is one of the best passing forwards in the world. We saw that in the semifinal. And if you let him stand out there, look over the defense and pass, it could be trouble. Here's another foul, the push by Marco Kessel on Kirilenko.
And Marco Kessel did a very good job defensively in the semifinal, and so far, I think his main goal right now would be to provide some good minutes defensively on Andrei Kirilenko.
Teodosic swings it to Šiškauskas inside to Kirilenko, baseline. Ilenko harassed, moves the ball out to Teodosic and inside to Nenad Kirstic. Kirstic spins, he's sandwiched by two defenders and throws the ball out of bounds. So good defensive reaction by Olympiacos on the guy who is the top scorer for CSKA Moscow. I mean,
immediately a double team and such a quick one. Pero Arti just gave over from the weak side and didn't get any chance to Kirstic to shoot a shot.
Banulis with the ball out top for Olympiacos. He's going to launch it from downtown. He's going to hit a three-pointer. The one and only Vasilis Banulis.
Only he can do it, Frank. He proved to be invaluable for Olympiacos in the semifinal on Friday. And here he scores a big three-pointer.
He puts his team up 2-5, and now there's an offensive foul called on Viktor Kriapa. The ball will be going the other way to Olympiacos, and they're shooting in the end where their fans are on their feet and likely be on their feet making noise the entire ball game.
I think that Olympiacos really feeds off the energy from its fans. They are on their feet, as you said, and Frank, they are starting to believe.
It was amazing how Olympiacos, as an underdog, controlled the entire 40 minutes against Barcelona the other night, whereas CSKA came out, dropped behind 14 points against Panathinaikos, but had the wherewithal to make that up before halftime and then go the rest of the game and win by two. Olympiacos gets it back to Spanoulis. He's going to take another jumper inside the three-point line. That's off the mark. And those CSKA rebounders pull it down. Sikowskis.
They just cleaned the boards. There's four red jerseys there on that defensive rebound.
Teodosic on top, shadowed by Mansadas. He gets it to Kirstic. And hands off again to Teodosic. Kriapa trying to go for Sikowskis, stolen by Mansadas. Throws to Dorsey. He collects it after almost losing it. Dorsey going against Kriapa, backs him down. Can't get the shot off. His pass is deflected. Teodosic still ahead to Kirstic on the fast break. But he travels with the ball. So another quick turnover by CSKA.
That's difficult because Nenad Kirstic was in full speed and he got the pass too early. I think they should have waited for one or two steps more so he got closer to the basket and then make the pass.
Three turnovers in less than 5 minutes for CSKA. They only average 13 per game. Spanoulis swings the ball around to Pedro Antis, back to Mansadas on the wing. But that was called a 3-second violation in the lane, negating that shot by Mansadas. So a three-pointer wasted on a 3-second violation by Olympiacos.
Rare mistakes there on both sides, as you saw, Frank.
That's three turnovers each so far. A four for CSKA, I'm sorry, and three for Olympiacos. Three up on top for CSKA. Inside to Kirilenko, but before he can try to get a ball up, he's fouled by Vasilis Panoulis.
But you see how closely he is watched, Frank. He received the ball under the basket, a very good shooting position, and immediately he's fouled before he gets a chance to get a shot off. They just don't want him to get going, and that's understandable.
We have a 2-5 score after 5 minutes. The Turkish Airlines EuroLeague final has been all defensive so far. The difference has been a three-pointer by Vasilis Panoulis. And George, you gotta like his leadership qualities. We know that Andrei Kirilenko is a superb leader from the defensive end for CSKA. But Panoulis, as we saw the other night in the semifinal, with the ball in his hands, has a chance to lead even more, perhaps.
Well, I mean, we said it, they are just different players. Panoulis just has the ball in his hands most of the time, and he makes all the crucial passes and shots. While Kirilenko, he's incredible defensively. He's all around. His active hands, active feet. He's blocking the shot from the weak side. It is really difficult to get on the inside and shoot an uncontested shot if Andrei Kirilenko is on the floor.
And we've talked also, George, about the young guys. These two rosters are full of veterans, strong veterans at the top, but give opportunity to young players. The only one out on the floor so far, Vangelis Mansadas, great defensive player himself on the ball, already has one steal and seems to be harassing Teodosic.
Oh, he's doing a superb job. He's very light on his feet. He dances around like a butterfly. He is really good. I mean, you see how he stays in front of the ball. He plays on the verge of conservative and being aggressive. He just knows the fine line how to attack the ball.
That is why Duda Ivkovic has made him a starter in 14 out of his 18 games on the roster this season, just turned 22 years old. He's got another 22-year-old just turned on the bench in Kostas Lukas, and 21-year-old Kostas Papanikolaou, who had a big, big game against Barcelona. On the other side, we're waiting to see Alexei Shved and Andrei Voronsevich, both a little older, but young guys getting their first chance at this Final Four. CSKA ball, Priap out top to Kirilenko to Teodosic. Teodosic takes pick and roll. He's got space. Tries to go to Kirstich. Another turnover.
That was a good defensive read there.
Mantzadas gets it across half court to Spanoulis. Spanoulis working on Šiškauskas. Gets around him. Goes back, fall back, shot off the rim.
That was a very difficult shot for Spanoulis because Šiškauskas is just so much bigger and he clearly bothered his shot.
No offensive rebounds in this game so far. Five on the defensive end for CSKA at 3-4 Olympiacos. So nobody's letting the other team get its shots back. It's one chance so far on every possession. Teodosic guarded by, he tries a shot and hits it from inside the arc despite the good defense of Mantzadas.
That was a veteran move. I mean, Teodosic just said, hey, I'm going to take this ball and show you that I can play one-on-one. Nice shot from the free throw line.
It's 4-5 and under 4 minutes left in the first quarter of this Turkish Airlines Euroleague final. And this foul is offensive as well as Joey Dorsey gets caught moving on a screen that denies another shot chance for Marco Kesha.
That was some movement there on the screen. Of course, the picks by the big guys are very important for the shooters to get open. And Joey Dorsey, like we said, he's a mountain of a man. He set some big screens.
It's CSKA Moscow looking for its first lead. They get the ball to Šiškauskas and to Kirstich. Teodosic inside to Kirilenko. Does anybody work the inside passing lanes getting open behind the defense better than Andrei Kirilenko?
Andrei Kirilenko is just super playing without the ball, Frank. That's the key. He plays so well without the ball. He doesn't need the ball to create a shooting opportunities. He doesn't need screens. He just keeps cutting. And there, as a big target on the inside, he is such an easy target to hit.
Kirilenko draws that foul. Second on Marco Kesha and gets the free throw line to tie this ball game up 5-5 as we see another of the youngsters of Olympiacos, Kostas Papanikolaou, come into the game. And Kirilenko puts his team ahead with two free throws. For the first time in this game, CSKA ahead, but they're starting much better than they did the semifinal the other night. Spanoulis out top. Goes to Antic. Hands off to Mantzadas. Cross court to Papanikolaou. Aggressive in the lane, spinning, going for a shot off the board. There's the youngster, Kostas Papanikolaou.
And look at that, Frank. I mean, I was going to ask you a rhetorical question, how he's going to have an impact if early on or not. And you see it right there, immediately catches the ball, goes to the basket, just like in the semifinal.
Šiškauskas bringing the ball up court and handing off to Teodosic. It's Olympiacos back out in front, 6-7. Teodosic lobs to Kirstich. He's way under the basket. And he gets bumped from behind by Joey Dorsey. Let's see if that.
That's right.
Fallon Dorsey will be his second. That's not good news for Olympiacos.
That is not good, and he's going to have to go to bench, and he will be substituted by Kyle Hines, another bit undersized man.
Now we will see the incredible story of Kyle Hines. He's only 1.95 meters, going up against bigger, taller men. Some of them holding almost 20 centimeters on him all season long. But Kyle Hines does not back down against anybody. He's 10th in the EuroLeague this season in offensive rebounds. So he knows exactly what to do when he's faced with a bigger guy. But it's Kirstich putting CSKA ahead again at the free throw line, 8-7.
Of course, defensively, Hines is going to have to push out the big people of CSKA as far out of the basket as he can.
Spanoulis, Alexei Shved in the game, guarding him for CSKA. Gets the ball in the corner, it swings to Peto Antic for a three-pointer off the rim, and there is Kyle Hines getting the rebound right away.
Good patience there by Olympiacos. Kyle Hines didn't rush anything on the rebound.
Spanoulis to Papanikolaou, makes his move, it's tipped by Kirilenko. He gets it to Hines. Spanoulis trying to break through the defense, it's stolen by Kirilenko, and CSKA's defense comes up with another one.
Great defense by CSKA, and Kirilenko is just everywhere.
Kriapa inside to Kirstis, working on Pino Antic. His hook shot misses, rebounded by Monsalas.
Good conservative defense there by Pino Antic.
Monsalas to Kyle Hines, goes to Spanoulis out top. It's Spanoulis in the corner to Pino Antic, misses everything and into the hands of Andrei Kirilenko.
That was a wild shot. I think Pino Antic got an advantage in quickness against Krstic, and he should have taken the drive against him.
Liapa on the wing goes right inside to Krstic. He's fouled before he can get to the basket. Let's see if the called the first foul on Hines, which may not be the shooting foul. We're called it on Papanikolaou coming from behind. Kyle Hines, foul is on Hines, and the shot was on the way, so Krstic will return to the free throw line. As we said, he led CSKA in points, I'm sorry, in the bonus. That's why they're going to the free throw line. He led CSKA in scoring with 14.3 points this season, and he went to the free throw line, fifth most free throws made of any player in the EuroLeague. This is almost four per game for Krstic. He's got a chance to get those four right in this last couple plays.
And Frank, in the first game that they play in top 16 in Piraeus, Greece, Krstic shot 12 free throws, so he was very active on the inside, just working hard for his position, and he was fouled a lot in that game.
He's a 78% free throw shooter, but missed the first one there. This one he gets back, so then at Krstic, 3-4 from the free throw line, has CSKA ahead 9-7. And we see Georgios Printezis come in the game for Olympiacos. So small lineup in there for Olympiacos. Kyle Hines is going to try a jumper from outside. That's off the mark. Rebounds loose and in the hands of Monsalas.
Did you see how hard Olympiacos goes after the boards with this quick lineup?
There are only two offensive boards in this game so far belong to Olympiacos. There's a jump ball. It's Sasha Cowan also in the game for CSKA, fighting for that rebound against Kyle Hines.
That was good active hands by Sasha Cowan. He just checked into the game and slapped the ball away from the hands of Kyle Hines. You see it right there, just tied up on the floor. It's a loose ball, and a jump ball situation aborted to CSKA Moscow.
Mistake by Hines, taking advantage of by CSKA.
I think it looks like CSKA is just picking up on the defense that they played against Panathinaikos, and they set the record with only 5 points they allowed to score Panathinaikos.
1 minute left, 1:10 in the first quarter. Slukas in the game guarding Shved. Shved makes his move, tries to get it to Cowan. It gets away, and Cowan commits a foul as Printezis just came up with a steal. So, George, it's a low-scoring first quarter, that's for sure, 9-7 with a minute left. You see a lot of nervousness combined with a lot of tremendous defense.
Exactly, Frank. I think it's perfect combination because the teams don't seem extremely nervous, but they are playing superb and alert defense.
6 turnovers each. CSKA on the average is 13, and Olympiacos the same 13, so that can be a test of the nervousness. Here's Hines. He gets it stolen again by Shved. Here comes CSKA the other way. Teodosic goes to Kirilenko in the corner. He's guarded and pulls it back out. A lot of good transition defense as well so far in this game. Teodosic on the loose. Makes it down the baseline. Kicks out to Kriapa. He's at a launch from 3-point distance, and he misses. The ball last touch by Kostas Slukas.
He just could not control the ball right there. It was a long rebound. Kostas Slukas tried to chase it down, but he could not hold on to the ball.
But surprisingly enough, with their rebounding or their height advantage, that's the first offensive rebound for CSKA in this game. And we're almost at the end of the first quarter.
I think everybody, Frank, really pays a lot of attention just to boxing out.
Shved with the ball out top, working on Slukas. Shot clock and game clock are pretty close at the end of this first quarter. Shved, we've seen him one step past people. Great first step he has, especially in that semifinal. Here he goes with the screen by Cowan, working on Hines. He gets pushed by Hines on the way to the basket, so that's a little bit of trouble for Olympiacos with 2 fouls on Hines and 2 fouls on Dorsey, not to mention Marco Kessel.
This is not good, but you saw the strength of Alexei Shved. Did you see how explosive he is off the ball? I mean, he just took it right at Kyle Hines, and he could not stay with him. And you said it, Kyle Hines is very quick on his feet at 1.95 meters.
7 seconds left and a timeout on the floor with CSKA in the first quarter, with CSKA leading 9-7. Alexei Shved going to the free throw line with a chance to make it four. Down for George, we have two games in the mid-60s finals. Strong defense, very, very physical. And of course, this game's starting the same way.
Well, I mean, it tells you that both coaches are really asking their players to play defense. Both of them spoke about it before the game in the press conferences, and even the players acknowledge it. They say, hey, we cannot change too much about our strategy, but we really have to focus on defense as a team from the first second.
George, if this game continues at this pace, we heard Dusko Ivkovic saying that in comparison to Friday when he wanted to attack fast and maybe run against Barcelona, still won a low-scoring game. His team learned a lot. Do you think which team does this pace benefit if it stays low-scoring?
Well, I mean, this is difficult to say because I think both teams would like to run and score some easy baskets. If you talk about Duda Ivkovic, I think he was pleased by the fact that they prevailed, that they managed to beat a great Barcelona team, even though they played a possession-for-possession slowdown game.
Alexei Shved coming back on court to take some free throws for CSKA Moscow. He's an 85% free throw shooter. Great shooter, this kid. We talk about his first step. He's the only player in the history of the EuroLeague after four or five seasons he's had now to have a 50% career three-point percentage. So this guy can shoot from everywhere as well as drive the basket, although he misses his first free throw.
Oh, he could be a great one, Frank. Shved, a lot of potential.
Shved rattles in the second one and goes off the floor. He's replaced by number 18, Eugeni Voronov, who did not play in the semifinal. He commits a foul with 3.9 seconds left. That's what he's in there for, to stop that fast break by Olympiacos. They had a foul to give, CSKA did.
And now
Jamal Gordon in the game also for CSKA for these last seconds.
Of course, now Coach Kozlowskis is signaling no more fouls.
Ball's loose. It's going to be Kyle Hines. It's going to be A.C. Law. Let's see if he got it off. But the shot didn't make it anyway. So A.C. Law entered the game, got a shot off. But that's where our first quarter ends with a 10. There we saw a little bit of history between these two teams, but nothing more important than this game. Their first Final Four game at all against each other. And for the trophy tonight, here we go in the second quarter action with CSKA 10-7 over Olympiacos. Top scorer so far, Nina Kirstich with 3 points for CSKA. Olympiacos' small lineup. Printezis is going to shoot from deep right at the start of the second quarter. Rebound ahead to Jamal Gordon. He saves it back, but A.C. Law has it. So they're breaking out the gates here in the second quarter. Law trying to go around Shved, gets fouled by Alexei Shved. I don't know, George, we talked about who this favors, but if you're the underdog, which is Olympiacos, a close scoreboard, whether it's 4 points or less, is always staying in striking distance of the favorite.
I mean, that's what you're trying to do if you're an underdog. Just keep it as close as you can, and towards the end of the game, I think the favorite tends to get more nervous.
Another foul on Shved drawn by Slukas, and that too is interesting to the benefit of Olympiacos, because Shved was just on fire on Friday. And if he has trouble getting started, it can only help Olympiacos.
And he just gives completely different look to the offense of CSKA, because he is so quick, Frank. We saw him beat anybody in the EuroLeague on the first step.
A.C. Law to Slukas across the Papanikolaou. He gets in the lane, falling down, got the pass off, but he lost it. And it was knocked out of bounds by Jamal Gordon. So Papanikolaou with a heads-up play after he accidentally fell on his drive. He kept the ball in his team's possession.
There is absolutely nothing for me tonight, Frank. I mean, it's been 10 and a half minutes and I have not seen one easy situation for either of the teams. They are just contesting and challenging everybody on each play.
The ball will remain with Olympiacos. We see A.C. Law, who came in the final seconds of the first quarter. Of course, he was injured on a turned ankle in the semifinal. We didn't know if he would play, but there he is out there. We'll see how he's doing. Georgios Printezis to the hoop, tries to get it to Kyle Hines. He goes out to A.C. Law, can't handle the pass, so it's another turnover. And you have to think that whether it's nerves or defense, the turnovers are piling up for these two teams. Eight each, George.
Look at that, Frank. 16 turnovers combined, and zero assists. That is an incredible ratio.
Especially when these teams do very well in both those departments. CSKA Moscow set the all-time EuroLeague record this season with 19.5 per game and had 25 or 26 in one of the games against Olympiacos. This is a different Olympiacos team, much more defensive than it was earlier in the season. Kirilenko baseline, can't get a shot, has to take a desperation shot. It misses. And the rebound fought for by Sasha Kahn. He draws the third foul on Kyle Hines. Big, big turn of events there. And Kyle Hines picking up his third foul.
Well, this could be a big complication for Olympiacos because you already have Joey Dorsey sitting with two fouls on the bench.
Fed out top for CSKA. He's going to launch a three-pointer. That's off the mark, and the rebound is Slukas.
Kostas Slukas is a big guard, and I think he will need to help his big man with rebounding.
He goes right inside the Printezis on the post. Printezis working against Piraeus, but gives it back to Slukas for a baseline jumper that misses. But Printezis has the rebound, trying to get the ball out. He gets fouled. Looks like Kirilenko gets hit with his first foul, I believe. Let's check on that. Kirilenko's first foul for him tonight.
But did you see that, Frank? They got an offensive rebound and there was nowhere to go. Absolutely nowhere to go for Georgios Printezis, so he just had to throw it out.
Even though you say that, George, Olympiacos, even with a small lineup out there for much of this time, is holding its own on the board so far.
Oh, absolutely. They are just giving it a lot of heart.
Printezis free inside, but he traveled before being challenged by Kirilenko from behind. Traveling called another turnover. You see Andre Vodoncevic in the game for CSKA Moscow, as well as Nedo Antic, who came in when Hines got his third foul.
But good position defense there by Vodoncevic. He just used his body to body up Printezis, and immediately Kirilenko came from the back and tried to bother Printezis and caused him to travel.
With the quick shooter that Printezis is, you have to do that. Here's Kirilenko at the other end. Gets the ball to Jamon Gordon going inside the count. Almost another turnover. Ball tipped. Shved comes up with it. Tries to go inside the count. Tip in by Andrei Kirilenko for the first basket of the second quarter.
Again, he is active. He stays with the ball and just brings it home.
AC Law on the wing working against Sasha Kahn. He has a mismatch. Let's see what he does with it. Law had the ankle problem. Drives on Kahn all the way to the basket. Misses. What a battle on a rebound. It was Vodoncevic up in the air tipping the ball, but he ran over Petr Antic to do it.
Petr Antic was trying just to tip the ball. And look at that right here. AC Law driving to the basket. It's a loose ball rebound. And right there, Andrei Vodoncevic just comes flying through the lane and hits Petr Antic, who was trying to tip it in. And this is the previous play. Look at Kirilenko. He stays there on the basket and he dips it back in. That's Andrei Kirilenko, active on both sides of the floor. That's what he does best. That's why he is the reigning MVP.
Kirilenko takes a seat on the bench as Miloš Teodosic returns, as well as Lamunas Šiškauskas for CSKA, and Vasilis Banulis back in the game for Olympiacos. It's a 5-0 run for CSKA. They lead 12-7, but the defense has been the story in this game so far. Antic to Spanoulis, guarded by Jamon Gordon. Spanoulis tries to get through the double team. Ball's loose, another turnover. Šiškauskas ahead to Jamon Gordon in the corner to Vodoncevic, and CSKA pulls it out. Teodosic to Vodoncevic from the wing. He misses, and AC Law comes the other way for Olympiacos. Jitterbugging through the lane, the ball's loose again. It's Jamon Gordon. He's having trouble handling it and pulls it out. Teodosic to Vodoncevic. And again, CSKA pulls it out to Šiškauskas. Wraparound pass, Šiškauskas to count, the easiest bucket of the night so far.
That's what they needed, Frank. They just needed to calm down, make an easy play. And what's easier in basketball than pick and roll? If you do it properly, that's what you get, an easy shot.
Pinches is trying to answer from downtown. That's a miss. And on the rebound, a foul on Šiškauskas. And he looks like young Kostas Papanikolaou got the worst of that. Look at that wraparound pass by Šiškauskas.
There was nobody on the help side. Nobody coming to help. The whole side was clear. Sasha Kahn just easy slam right there. Good play.
Šiškauskas wrapped that around two players, his own man and Petr Antic. But now Papanikolaou will go to the free throw line with a bonus situation, knock down a much, much needed point for his team, who's been having all sorts of trouble scoring midway through the second quarter. Yeah,
this will be important because Olympiacos just cannot find a way to score, but right now, after 3 minutes and 16 seconds, they are already in bonus, right?
Not only are they in bonus, but Spanoulis has drawn more fouls than any player in the EuroLeague this season and made more free throws than any player in the EuroLeague this season. So we'll see if that has an effect. 14-9. Second quarter action, Turkish Airlines Euroleague Final Four, Teodosic to Kirstic for two.
Again, guard for the big man. Good cooperation with Nenad Kirstic, sealing his man, getting the ball in a good position and scoring easy two.
Spanoulis out top for Olympiacos. Working on Volan Savic. Gets it into Printezis with a mismatch. Ojemai Gordon, his little jumper comes out, his jump hook, and Teodosic with the rebound.
It's not easy to back down Javon Gordon.
Straight inside to Kirstic, backs in, doesn't get the shot. And Papanikolaou with the rebound. Spanoulis on the run, going right at Kirstic, and finishes Vasilis Spanoulis.
How difficult is that shot? He just flies into Kirstic and then backs in. What a play there!
16-11, timeout on the floor. 6 minutes left to play until halftime. The Turkish Airlines EuroLeague final, one of these teams, CSKA Moscow, ahead 16-11, or Olympiacos will be a champion tonight after a long, long season of trying to get to this game. So far, it's been a defensive battle out here on the floor. The high scorer in this game is Nenad Kirstic with 5 points. He's matched by Vasilis Spanoulis of Olympiacos with five himself. Kostas Papanikolaou with four out there on the floor. And we're, at this point, Siska's had a couple assists, and that is a different. Remember, Siska broke the EuroLeague record since 2000 with 19.5 assists per game. They've only managed to get two so far tonight. Olympiacos zero. It's amazing how much the defenses are dominating, and the referees letting them play. It's going to be a defensive struggle, it looks like.
And I think a few times, Fran, the ball just bobbled out of the hands of the players there on easy situations. Sometimes they didn't catch the ball. So I would also say that the nerves are working right here. But truly a mind-blowing statistic. There's only two assists so far in the game. And if you compute how much they have in the season on average together, it's almost 34 assists. And right now they are standing at two. And we have already played 14 minutes of the game.
Another factor, the block shots. We saw one block early in the game, but since then, Olympiacos has been getting some offensive rebounds, pulling the ball out, not risking the blocks, but they're not getting hurt too much around the rim with blocks just yet.
Well, I mean, CSKA is attacking the boards, but they are holding their own, as you said. I mean, they have trouble with Hines with three fouls and two for Joey Dorsey.
Goran Savic on the wing for CSKA, gets it to Teodosic for an open three. He knocks it down. Milos Teodosic has CSKA leading 19-11.
That was a good play set up at the timeout by Jonas Kozlowskas. Perfect execution and a three-pointer for CSKA Moscow.
Printezis back to Spanoulis. Jamal Gordon doing a good defensive job on him. Spanoulis to Papanikolaou for a slam.
That was a perfect play. Penetration and kick and a strong finish by Kostas Papanikolaou. He likes that. Get it on the move and stuff it home.
What a cut by Papanikolaou. What a pass by Spanoulis. That could uncork. Here's Teodosic again from downtown. Same play, same shot, same answer.
He better not get going, because if he gets hot, that's big time trouble for Olympiacos.
22-13 for CSKA. Spanoulis to Printezis, around to AC Law. Baseline one-hander off the mark. Rebound by Nenad Kirstic.
That was a little bit of a weak shot. He shot him his offhand. It was penetrating to the baseline. Another three.
Whoa! Teodosic is feeling it. He's got three three-pointers in a row. And CSKA Moscow ahead 25-13 on the scoreboard.
Look at that. Three threes in a row by Milos Teodosic. He hit a key three-pointer in the semifinal, and he's doing it early for CSKA Moscow.
George, he looked like he would have taken that at half court if they gave him the ball. Here they come, three in a row. Nice play to get them open on the first one. Same play, Teodosic again. Both of those rattled in, but once he knew he had his mark, look at him from way downtown on the third one. Nobody gets near him. And Milos Teodosic with 9 points in a minute and a half has turned the scoreboard around. It was a close game just a couple minutes ago. It's now 25-13 with 4:30 to play in the first half. CSKA exploding in the middle of the second quarter.
But Frank, did you see how far was the third one? I mean, he was coming down the floor with so much confidence. As you said, he would have taken it from the locker room.
Well, Milos Teodosic came to CSKA this year from Olympiacos. He had this team in the Final Four 2 years ago when he was the MVP of the EuroLeague for Olympiacos. This year he switched teams and he has put some darts on his old team right there, three in a row. They know him better than anybody, but they couldn't stop Milos Teodosic from breaking out here in the second quarter.
That's Vangelis Montanis is getting back on the court. A clear defensive assignment for him just to stop Teodosic.
He did a great job of it in the first quarter. We also see Lazarus Papadopoulos getting his first Final Four action for Olympiacos, although he's a former EuroLeague champion with Panathinaikos. Let's see, they go right inside him. Papadopoulos spins, and he gets fouled by Kirstich right away. So nice call, trying to get the ball to Papadopoulos, bring him on the court, to make his moves in the post.
That's good. I mean, if they keep Kirstich occupied their own defense, that's good news for Olympiacos. And right there, immediately, Jonas Kozlovskis recognizes that he's going to sit and rest without Kirstich, and he's going to use Lavrinovic instead.
Lavrinovic, Darius Lavrinovic coming in the game for CSKA Moscow. And Papadopoulos, who has been sitting for much of the season with injury, certainly the latter part of the season, goes to the free throw line, misses the first one. He did not suit up for Friday's semifinal, but he's in there tonight for Olympiacos and trying to give them some help here in the second quarter. He appeared in a couple playoff games, didn't get much going, didn't get much time.
He is not a good free throw shooter. He's averaging 20% for the season.
Papadopoulos draws the foul, but can't take advantage of it. And there's Teodosic with the ball guarded by Spanoulis. He has been the man of the moment with 3 three-pointers in a row. Gives it up to Voronsevic. Lavrinovic, 4 on the shot clock. Gets it to Jamal Gordon. He's going to launch from deep. Almost makes it. Rebound to Lavrinovic.
Lavrinovic is very active. He chased down the long rebound. Very smart player. He knows he read the ball well and where he was going to bounce.
Back to Teodosic. He gets free. But there's a foul on Lavrinovic on the screen, moving too quickly. Well, on an offensive foul, a turnover for CSKA.
I think he just got there half a step late and just moved in the screen a little bit.
3:37 left in this first half, George, and CSKA up 12, holding Olympiacos to just 13 points so far. What does Olympiacos have to do?
I think they just have to start attacking as early as they can, but it's really difficult against the defense of CSKA's play.
Manolas attacks, he gets fouled, and he will go to the free throw line.
Frank, I mean, we spoke about Barcelona coming here as the best defensive player. I mean, defensive team, but look at CSKA. I mean, they are not giving anything for free. And they started on Friday in the semifinal against Panathinaikos. But they are keeping it in the same style tonight.
Jamal Gordon goes out for CSKA. Siskauskas comes back in the game. It's Panoulis getting to the free throw line. He's got 3.5 minutes left with the CSKA and the bonus in this half. And as we said, he goes to the free throw line more than any player in the EuroLeague, making more free throws. He finished as the second leading scorer this season in the EuroLeague with 16.7 points per game. And he knocks down the first of his 2 free throws. He's 84% free throw shooter for the season. Much needed, every single point for Olympiacos. Somebody was in the lane, so Spanoulis will get a chance to take that second free throw.
I think it's exactly right, Frank. I mean, with the defense and with 14 points on the board, any point they can score.
Spanoulis misses the second try as well. Very unusual for him. So his team is still down 11, 25-14. Teodosic brings it across half court for CSKA. Gets it to Voronsevic. Back to Teodosic. Shadowed by two defenders. Great pass to Lavrinovic, who finishes. No look. Backward pass. Teodosic to Lavrinovic. Miloš Teodosic has come to play.
Oh, he's dominating this final so far. It was a beautiful pass. All balance, no look.
Defense of CSKA, Papanikolaou. He drops a three-pointer. He answers back. Kostas Papanikolaou from deep for Olympiakos.
Kostas Papanikolaou again giving a big boost to his team. Let's see how he can keep going at this style.
Lavrinovic inside to Kirilenko. That's money in the bank. He puts two in as well.
And that was a good backpick there for Kirilenko because Papanikolaou got stuck there on the screen and Kirilenko was wide open right under the basket.
Still a 12-point lead for CSKA, 29-17. Spanoulis driving to the basket. He finishes as well. This is loosening up at the end of the first half, George.
That's a good job by Spanoulis. He's attacking the basket right he did in semifinal. He had a little bit of trouble at the beginning of the game, but now two times in a row successfully.
Foul in the open court by Papanikolaou. The young guy going against Kirilenko, trying for the steal, knocks him down. But Olympiakos has fouls to give at the end of this half.
It's only first foul for Papanikolaou, and as you said, Olympiakos has fouls to give, so they can afford to be aggressive.
Teodosic guarded by Spanoulis. Dusiskauskas. He goes strong to the basket and finishes. Ramunas Juskauskas against Papadopoulos.
That was a power shot right there because Papadopoulos was in the way of Juskauskas and he just moved him out of the way.
Back to a 12-point lead. Here's Spanoulis from deep off the front of the rim. Rebound fought for and grabbed by Teodosic.
And I think that they, Olympiakos, will have to start moving the ball better on offense. I guess what Budai could have called for before the game. They need a better ball movement, involve more players.
Teodosic with the ball to Kirilenko, drives the lane, goes to Lavrinovic, working on Papadopoulos, loses his footing, travels, and that will be a turnover for CSKA Moscow. They're up to 10. Olympiakos is up to 12. They're almost reaching their averages before the end of the first half. It's just a defensive masterpiece so far.
I mean, Jonas Kozlowskis cannot be any happier. I think the players are completely focused. Look at that body language of CSKA. Oh, everybody is extremely focused.
Papadopoulos tries to dish to Spanoulis on the cut, but it was kicked by Lavrinovic. It will stay Olympiakos' ball. They've only got 114 to try to 114 before halftime, trying to get this into back to single digits. They've been behind by more 10 or more for a little while. Here's Papadopoulos in the post. Tries to go to the corner, stolen by Kirilenko. Another turnover for Olympiakos.
Such long and active arms in the lane. That's a big time danger if you're playing against Andrei Kirilenko.
Lavrinovic trying for and making a short jumper. Nice move by him. And the lead is being stretched here in the final minute of the first half. CSKA up by 14. Almost another steal by Kriapa on the floor, throwing his body around.
CSKA is just smelling the blood. Like they are all over the place. They are diving on the floor. They are overplaying the lanes. They are so active. I mean, if there was any question if CSKA was going to feel any pressure, here's your answer. I mean, they came ready to play.
43 seconds left until halftime and a 14-point lead for CSKA. We see Ejine Voronov back in the game for CSKA. Ball goes to Mansadis, who gets it to Papadopoulos, who gets it to Spanoulis. Spanoulis fouled from behind by Juskauskas.
That was a smart play because Spanoulis just felt the contact. But Ramunas Juskauskas on his back and just waited for the foul to happen.
Draws a third foul on Ramunas Juskauskas, who is nothing less than a former MVP of the EuroLeague himself and has been a two-time EuroLeague champion. So we'll see how much his foul trouble affects him when we come back for the second half. But we still have 36 seconds left in this one. And Spanoulis doing everything he can to try to inch his team forward.
If you remember, Juskauskas kind of started this run of CSKA. He did a nice pick and roll with one of his big men, Sasha Kalur. So three fouls for him could be a factor too for Jonas Juskauskas.
For sure. Spanoulis hits the first free throw. This is the second, very unusual. He's missing free throws so far, we'll see the Spanoulis. Fed with the ball, guarded by Spanoulis on top. He took it near the end of the first quarter as well. Let's see if Sved gets the call again, makes his move, goes to Lavrinovic for a three-point try. And a foul on the play by Spanoulis. Let's see. Lavrinovic, much taller than Spanoulis, shoots over him. This is the shot, and he'll be going to the free throw line for three big free throws with 16.7 left, 7 seconds left in the first half. Let's see, there's the touch on the elbow, spotted by the referee, good call. Touch on the elbow by Spanoulis as Lavrinovic was shooting that shot.
Absolutely, Frank, and I think it just comes from the fact that Lavrinovic must be respected for his three-point shooting ability. He's a very good three-point shooter.
He should be respected for his free throw shooting ability, even though he didn't hit the first one. He's 95% for the season. Misses two. Let me double check that. What's going on, George? This is finals nerves.
I mean, we got Vasilis Spanoulis, as you said, missing the free throws on the side of Olympiacos, and now that is Lavrinovic. The same story right there.
There he is.
Only one out of three.
He gets the third one. He comes out of the game for Andre Voronsev. 16.7 seconds left, 34-20. CSKA lead, ball in the hands of Spanoulis for Olympiacos. Any points they get back here will be appreciated by their fans. Spanoulis kicks to Printezis for a three, off the mark. Ball is loose, and it's Voronov with a rebound. Shred for the shot. Let's see if it counts. Let's see if it counts. He made it.
I think they're gonna watch the video.
I think it was a three-pointer. I don't even know if his foot was on the line. The shot went in, there's no doubt about that. But the lights on the scoreboard were lit with the ball in the air. I think the referees are gonna check it out and see if this shot was off before the buzzer sounded. We shall see, they'll do a video replay here at the end of the half. It's 34-20 before that shot falls. And we will find out what the true halftime score is while we wait for the referees to make their decision.
Oh, what a dynamic game right there. I mean, maybe the shot was taken a little bit too early by Printezis on the side of Olympiacos. That gave 5 seconds for CSKA to go across the court. And you know how fast CSKA players and how immediately they know how to react. Sved got an open look, shot it, and now let's see if it counts or not, Frank.
Turkish Airlines, 7 days, and Winline. Official global sponsors in association with the Turkish Airlines Euroleague.
Here we see the ceremony on the court, which is the symbolic passing of the baton of this final four, which this year is in Istanbul, Turkey. And earlier this weekend was announced that next year, and possibly in 2014 as well, will be in London, England at O2 Arena in London. Going to a big international city without a EuroLeague team for at least the next year. So London now has the baton. They'll be doing the Olympics this summer, so they'll be getting ready for the Turkish Airlines Final Four in 2013 at O2 Arena in London, England. We are getting ready here now for the second half of tonight's final, in which CSKA Moscow is taking control at halftime, 34-20. George, if you're Dusko Ivkovic of Olympiacos, what do you want your team to show at the start of the second half?
Well, it's nothing to hold back, Frank. I mean, you're down 14 against a paper favorite, against a team that was built to win Final Four, the EuroLeague. So I think that you just have to tell the guys, hey, guys, this is possibly the last 20 minutes of the season, so let's go out and play, have fun, and just do what we do best. Just play together and attack.
Some changes from the starting lineups now at the start of the second half. AC Law and Kostas Papanikolaou in for Olympiacos, along with their starters, Vasilis Spanoulis, Petr Antic, and Joey Dorsey. Whereas the starters, four of the starters for CSKA Moscow are out there, along with Alexei Shved replacing Ramunas Shishkaskas, who has three fouls. Teodosic, the first half hero, now passes off. The ball goes to Shved, working against Dorsey, gets it to Kriapa inside. The Kirstich for a quick hook shot, so the beat goes on for CSKA Moscow.
That's a beautiful execution right there. Patience and a good position by Kirstich, close to the basket, beautiful hook shot.
Spanoulis out top for Olympiacos, gets it to Petr Antic. He's got a mismatch against Shved. He goes in for a hook shot, and he gets the first basket of this half as well. Game, the second half starting like the game started.
All right, good play on both sides. Petr Antic got also close to the basket. He executed perfectly.
It's Kriap out top for CSKA. There's Shved on the wing. Oh, he fakes Spanoulis. Gets the ball to Kirstic, and another quick basket for Nenad Kirstic. He's piling up the points now.
And Nenad Kirstic is just making himself very big in that Olympiacos Spain.
It's 38-32. He's up to 9 points. Spanoulis kicks it around to Papanikolaou for a three. He knocks it down. Papanikolaou with another three-pointer.
Look at Papanikolaou just squaring up and taking that three in the face of Andrei Kirilenko.
He hasn't missed a shot tonight. He's up to 12 points without a miss. Kriap working on Antic, trying to go around, but he gets bumped on the way to the basket. So a foul on Petr Antic will keep the ball.
Good recognition there by Viktor Kriap. He faked the handoff, but then of course, he has the speed advantage over Petr Antic from the outside, so he just took advantage of that.
Second foul on Antic. Kirilenko to Teodosic, guarded by AC Law. Three-pointer by Teodosic, hits the mark again.
And I think that AC Law just has to do a better job of getting over the screen because he got hung up there, and he cannot give so much space to red-hot Miloš Teodosic.
4 for 5 from downtown, Teodosic. Antic going to the rim, he's gonna try to slam. Foul by Kirstic, but Kirstic was able to stop the shot. But what about Miloš Teodosic? He's been a EuroLeague MVP with Olympiacos. He's trying to win the Final Four MVP trophy against Olympiacos tonight.
Frank, I just think on that last three, he got so much room that you cannot do that. I mean, he has scored 3 threes in succession in the first half, and you cannot leave the guy open like that.
Looking incredibly comfortable, Miloš Teodosic from downtown.
Right, you know how he's dangerous. He's got a mindset of a scorer, of a shooter from the outside, and if you leave a guy like that, if he's hot, open, you're asking for trouble.
Petr Antic drops a free throw, but his team's behind 15 points right now. So they're gonna have a tough time coming back without a lot more defense on Teodosic. There's Antic hitting the next shot as well. Down 41-27, CSKA in charge. Time ticking away in the third quarter. Under 8 minutes left in the third quarter of the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague title game.
If Olympiacos speaks about it itself as a defensive team, it's time to play the defense right now.
Kirilenko gives it up. The ball picked up by Papanikolaou. He's running with Spanoulis. Spanoulis is going to take a three-pointer in transition, and he hits it too. This thing's heating up, George, from downtown.
Look at that. Exactly as we said, Olympiacos needs to pick it up. They just cannot save anything for tomorrow because there simply is no tomorrow.
Teodosic in the lane tries to pass to Kirilenko. It's loose and out of bounds. Last touch apparently by AC Law. It'll stay CSKA ball.
CSKA is staying with it. I mean, I think they're just going to go to some simple plays like the pick and roll. They're just going to work the clock. And I think they should try to involve Andrei Kirilenko into the offense as well.
Teodosic out top. Still got the ball. He's going to turn around jumper off the mark. Rebounds free. Fought for. Picked up by Law. He dribbles off his foot and out of bounds. So a big turnover. Shved put the stop on that fast break and forced the turnover.
I can't help it. And I think that the injury from Friday is affecting AC Law because he is not as explosive and not focused as he was on Friday or the games before. Speaking about the playoffs, he was just absolutely superb there.
Alexei Shved cross court to Kriap inside to Kirstic. Kriap is going to launch from downtown. In and out. Rebound by Joey Dorsey. And ahead to Spanoulis.
Good job by Dorsey just keeping Kirstic out of the paint and now rebounding.
Spanoulis out top, goes to Papanikolaou. Law swings it back out to Spanoulis. He takes another three-pointer off the mark, going towards the corner, rebound. Doesn't happen, the ball goes out of bounds, it will be CSKA basketball.
I would like Olympiacos to move the ball a little bit better. the time before when Spanoulis was taking the open three on the fast break, that's okay. But right now on the set offense, I think that Olympiacos needs to send the players cutting through the lane a lot more.
I'm sure Coach Ivkovic would like to see some inside-out movement with the ball, but with the Steelers inside for CSKA, tough to get a pass in to put it back out again. Here's Teodosic. Gets it to Kriapa, he'll launch another three. This one he rattles down. Victor Kriapa joining the three-point party and has CSKA 44-30.
That was an important basket by Victor Kriapa because somebody else is doing the shooting from the outside and Teodosic.
Granulis out top, working with Dorsey. Goes all the way in and gets fouled by Kirstich. He'll be going to the free throw line, but the third foul and then at Kirstich, George.
That was a good attack right there by Spanoulis. He did it in the first half, Frank, if you remember. He just attacked Kirstich. Regardless, Spanoulis is 1 meter 93 and Kirstich is 2 meter 12. I mean, what a gutsy play right there by Vasilis Spanoulis, but we've been seeing that from him all season long.
It's only the third trip to the free throw line for Spanoulis, and he's 2 for 4 so far. This is another one, George.
That's a third free throw missed by Vasilis Spanoulis in tonight's game.
Very, very unusual for him. He's an 80% free throw shooter. Knocks down the second one, so he's 3 for 6 and up to 13 points. But his team is still down by the same amount, 13. Shved on the run, Shved's going inside, but he pulls it out. Kirilenko's going to toss up a three and knock it down. It's shooting time after the Turkish Airlines Euroleague final.
And if shooting was not happening for CSKA in the semifinal, it's the main facet in the game in the final.
This team is one of the best three-point shooting teams in the Euroleague, ranked second with 39.2% this season, hitting 174 of them. So they can shoot the three. CSKA Moscow right now up to 6 in this game. Inside, Papanikolaou goes to Antic for a three-pointer. Up, off the mark, and into the hands of Kriapa with a big rebound.
Frank, if you combine the deadly defense by CSKA and their outside shooting, I mean, that's a lethal combination.
And we're seeing it right here. They're up 16 now. Kriapa with the ball. The Teodosic from deep, off the mark. Front of the rim, but rebounded by Kirilenko. Teodosic out top. They're going to run another play. Kirilenko has it. Shadowed by Papanikolaou. And an offensive foul in the lane. Looks like it'll be on Sasha Kaun, trying to make a screen for either Teodosic or Kriapa, but he gets called for the offensive foul.
I think Sasha just got a little bit overexcited there, trying to set the screen for the shooters.
Timeout on the floor in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague final. We've got a 47-31 scoreboard. And while we wait for the action to come back, we'll take a look at our Inside the Game feature on Andrei Vorontsevich. 47-31, as I said. You see the FS Pilsen cheerleaders on the floor. Now we'll take a look at our Inside the Game feature on CSKA forward Andrei Vorontsevich.
Power forward Andrei Vorontsevich seems to fly higher every season for CSKA Moscow. From a little-used teenager who debuted in 2006, Vorontsevich has grown into a rim rocker, consistently wreaking havoc off CSKA's bench. Along the way, he raised their EuroLeague trophy in 2008, and this season became the player with the most consecutive seasons wearing CSKA red. Despite playing behind star veterans like Matias Smodis and Andrei Kirilenko, Vorontsevich has always found ways to improve. Four of his best 5 performances in 70 career EuroLeague games came this season, and his flashy dunking helped him hit 64% of his two-point shots, fourth best in the EuroLeague, making Vorontsevich a sure thing for CSKA fans.
I think for this team like CSKA, it doesn't matter which player score a lot of points. Maybe you don't score, maybe you score little points, but you take the rebounds, help on defense, do a lot of hard work, just hustling all the time. I think this is the key for this team.
Third quarter action in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague title game, 47-31. CSKA Moscow leading at this moment. And Olympiacos running out of time. They're going to have to make a move after that timeout.
They're going to have to pick it up. You're right, Frank, because it's only 4 minutes and 45 seconds left in the third quarter. And they are down 16. And that is not easy of a hole to climb out of against CSKA Moscow, who is defending superbly and is shooting the lights out.
And Pedro Antic going to the free throw line for Olympiacos. And remarkable fact that we just saw on the screen, George, all the points of Olympiacos shared by three players. Vanoulis with 13, Papanikolaou with 12, and Antic with 6 before these free throws.
That is amazing. If you have only three players scoring all the points, that is not the greatest news, and it's going to stay that way because it's Pedro Antic who is on the free throw line. He makes only one, so it's a 15-point game.
And the free throws are starting to hurt Olympiacos. They're only 7 for 12 so far in this game. They can't afford that with this deficit they're facing against an incredible CSKA Moscow team.
They cannot afford any tiny mistake if they want to get back into this game.
Siskauskas on the wing gets it over to Kriapa, steps in for a two-pointer off the mark, and a foul on the rebound by Sasha Kahn, knocking Spanoulis for a loop. Ball will go to Olympiacos. 4:21 left in the third quarter, and Georgidek, he goes to the free throw line. It seems like drawing fouls against that aggressive CSKA defense is the offensive thing that's working now for Olympiacos.
Well, I mean, Olympiacos just gonna take any points they can get. There was a mix-up there around the basket, and Spanoulis just got there in the rebounding position, and Sasha Kahn extended his arm and was called for the foul. So two free throws for Vasily Spanoulis, who has missed three free throws quite unexpectedly if you look at his average for the season.
Well, he missed the first one each other time, so he got one this time. George, he may be missing some free throws, but do you have any doubt that if there's one leader who can bring a team back under these conditions, it might be Vasily Spanoulis?
But Frank, he will need help. He will need help against CSKA. He cannot do it single-handedly. That is my opinion about this.
Kirilenko bringing the ball up and dribbles it out of bounds on the defensive pressure by Papanikolaou.
That's it right there. You spoke about Papanikolaou just giving a huge lift to Olympiacos in the semifinal, and he is very active again in this game.
We see AC Law favoring that hurt ankle. He's on the court. Let's see if there's much he can do against his CSKA team. Pedro Antic has a foul on the screen. It's an offensive foul. And it looks like it's the third one on Joey Dorsey, who's having a rough game in his first final.
This is very difficult for Olympiacos to take because they had a chance at a mini run right there.
Joey Dorsey with only 2 rebounds, 5 turnovers, and 3 fouls now, having it rough in his first EuroLeague final against CSKA. Teodosic, shadowed by Law, gets into Kirilenko. Kirilenko with a foul and turnover as Papanikolaou facing up to the MVP.
And he is
doing his job so far.
He's all over the place. He was chasing Kirilenko from the back just a moment ago. Right now he just steps in front of him and just takes him on his chest and takes the charge.
Great job by the youngster.
Look at that right here. Andrei Kirilenko just goes into him and lowers his shoulder. And Papanikolaou takes it, one for the team.
No doubt about it, Kostas Papanikolaou had the position, forced the turnover, and those are the kind of plays that Olympiacos will have to make if they're gonna make up this 13-point difference now. A little under 4 minutes left in the third quarter of the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague final title game here in Istanbul, Turkey. Timeout on the floor with 47-34 on the scoreboard.
I'm seeing Kostas Lukas taking off his warm-up, so he's going to be checking in, I believe, for AC Law, and also Kyle Hines, who's got 3 personal fouls. He's going to be checking back into the game. Frank, he's held scoreless so far, and he was a big factor for the Olympiacos team, especially in the playoffs, in a phenomenal success against Montepaschi Siena. He was just a player that they could have relied on.
George? All the Olympiacos players are scoreless except for Papanikolaou, Vanoulis, and Pedro Antic. Unbelievable.
So I should take it from the other way around. I just should say who who scored some points rather than naming the players who has not scored, but it's the majority of them.
It's a longer list, those who haven't scored. Kyle Hines in the game, Kostas Lukas in the game. He's been a big playmaker for them during the season. Another 22-year-old for Olympiakos. And Georgios Printezis is also in the game. So a big, small lineup out there for the Reds of Olympiakos. Panoulis out top working with Kyle Hines, trying to get around the double team. Goes to Lukas inside to Printezis. The pass to Papanikolaou. And he loses the ball out of bounds with some tough defense, trying to make a wraparound pass, couldn't get it, and another turnover, George, for Olympiakos.
There was nothing there for Kostas Papanikolaou, but Frank, I think that one of the trio of Hines, Dorsey, and Printezis just have to step up. Frank, if you remember the later part of the season, always one of those guys, or ideally all three of them, are just the main guys for the team. Frank, they need to come to play.
Ned Osic crosses half court going against Lukas. To Kriop, guarded by Printezis. They go inside to Tiskasis. He's got a mismatch. Edmund puts a shot down on the post up. Ramunas Tiskasis has Ciska up 15. 13 minutes left in the game.
That's a very smart play to post up Šiškauskas against Panoulis. He just has to take advantage of his size every time down.
Panoulis in the corner to Printezis. He drives this time, spins, tries to finish. No, gets it to Papanikolaou. Inside to Hines. The ball's loose, but Hines stepped on the end line. George, that is turnover number 18 on Olympiakos. But still more than 12 minutes left in this game.
I mean, do you see how active the CSKA defense is? There's nothing. There are no holes. There are no weaknesses for the Russian team. They are playing the best defense I have seen this season. Any team play.
Absolutely inspired CSKA defense. They were the top scoring team in the EuroLeague. And they're turning on the D here in the final. Jermon Gordon in the game with the ball for CSKA. Gets a screen, goes inside. Trying to go up over Hines, and he gets it in. It's now a 17-point lead for CSKA, 51-34, and it's getting tougher and tougher for Olympiakos. Ispanoulis moves the ball around to Lukas, tries to go inside, another turnover. It's all CSKA right now, ahead to Sved for the layup on the break. CSKA Moscow taking the full control with a 19-point lead in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague final, 53-34. Another timeout on the floor by Olympiakos. And George Zidek, let's remind people about the pride of CSKA Moscow.
Olympiakos just cannot find absolutely anything going right for them. They are trying to penetrate, they are trying to attack the defense of CSKA, but the paint, it's so congested that they just have trouble getting the ball to their big man who could finish it. I think either they start shooting from the outside and they better start getting to it because it's 19 points down with 12 minutes to go or this game is over.
Well, they certainly have a better opportunity shooting, trying their three-point shots if they get them halfway open, because once they go in the middle, it's nothing but trouble.
There's nothing. Everybody's sagging from the weak side for CSKA Moscow. They are just doing a superb job of congesting the interior room around the basket.
I was going to say, remind people about the pride of CSKA Moscow. This team won its first four EuroLeague titles back in the early, mid-60s, late-60s, and early-70s. Waited 35 years to win one again in 2007 in Prague, your city, George. Came back 2 years later, won in Madrid to get up to six. They are tied for second place on the all-time list with Panathinaikos, who they beat on Friday night, dethroning those ex-champions. And now they're going to try to move into second place after they reached eight EuroLeague Final Fours in a row and had their streak interrupted, not even making the second round last year. Come back strong and trying to close out this final. Lukas for Olympiakos gets fouled by Sasha Kahn, so he'll be going to the free throw line. Kostas Lukas, that's about all that CSKA's given them.
And Sasha Kahn with his foul is going to go to the bench as he's got a fourth foul. And Darius Lavrinovic is coming back to the court. And he had very good first half, Frank. He was very active on offense.
CSKA defense has just given up foul shots and nothing more lately. Lukas, a 91% free throw shooter, misses as well. George, this has got to be symptomatic of some sort of nerves or being out of sync on this team. Big free throw shooters are missing them.
I mean, I think here the experience factor also comes into play, Frank. Olympiacos is a very young team. We spoke about it on Friday. They have 10 new players, and maybe right now their self-confidence is just really being shaken up.
Little pressure on the ball. Monsadas back in the game. Guard Jamal Gordon for Olympiacos. He stopped the pops, however. Monsadas pulls down the rebound. Gets it to Slukas on the wing, using the screen by Hines. Pass inside, Slukas to Hines, it misses right at the basket. Tough roll for Kyle Hines.
Right there, close to the basket. It almost seemed like the ball was going in, but it just rolled out on Kyle Hines.
Fed out top for CSKA. Almost loses it, stolen by Slukas. He's on the run. Straight down the middle, goes to Printezis, his first face pass break, basket I can remember for Olympiacos.
In a very long time, and that's what Olympiacos is good at. The young guys just getting the ball up the court, running and attacking.
That's why this small lineup's on the floor. Monsadas fouls Jamal Gordon. They've got another foul to give here in the final minute of the third quarter. There's 51 seconds left. Olympiacos, they are already in desperation time, even though we have a whole fourth quarter to play.
Oh yeah, they down big 16 points against CSKA. That's not a good news.
Shved goes to Gordon across court. Back to Shved on the wing. Shved's gonna take a run and jumper and miss. Ball is loose. Shved fighting for it. And we'll see who the foul is on. Could be Monsadas from behind. No, it goes the other way. It's Shved with the foul on the rebound. That would put Monsadas, I believe, on the free throw line.
And Jonas Kozlauskas is upset about it because he's just gesturing towards Shved to come over to him and just trying to explain to him that times on CSKA side, they don't have to rush anywhere. They just need to take smart shots, open shots, because you already see that Olympiacos defense is scrambling, Frank.
Another missed free throw for Olympiacos, but in this case, it's not one of their great free throw shooters. Monsadas, only 45% for the season, misses both. And the rebound goes to CSKA. Shved cross in half court. Just things that Olympiacos can't afford now.
Absolutely. They have missed too many free throws in the game. 8 right now.
They almost steal. They knock the ball out of bounds. Their small guys on defense are all over the place, but they're not taking advantage at the other end of the court. That ball stays CSKA possession, and each one from now on with a 16-point difference on the scoreboard and 28 seconds left in the third quarter. Each missed opportunity could be trouble for Olympiacos.
That's very costly, and right here you see a substitution to calm things down for CSKA. Miloš Teodosic comes back on the court, and he demands the ball immediately.
Three-point try by Teodosic. He misses this one. He's been hitting them all night. Here comes Slukas the other way for Olympiacos. Monsadas, he's going to try a three. He's going to hit a three. He doesn't hit the free throws, but he hits a three-pointer on the buzzer. Evangelos Monsadas to give a little lift to Olympiacos, backward in 13-53-40 at the end of three quarters in the Turkish Airlines EuroLeague title game.
Well, it gives a lot of hope to Olympiacos. It's a 13-point game, so if you look at it technically, Olympiacos won this quarter by 1 point. So it gives a little bit of a lift, but right now it's 10 final minutes, you're down 13. So I think, Frank, Olympiacos either plays the best game of the season or they don't have a chance.
Well, Monsadas with that three-pointer, sometimes that gives a psychological boost to teams, because in the middle of that third quarter, CSKA poured it on. We're leading by 19, and just in the last minute and a half, it's been a 6-0 Olympiacos run to get it back down to 13. But they've got to, the way the CSKA defense has been playing, Olympiacos is going to have to get it to single digits before long if they want to have a shot at this title tonight.
Oh, they don't have to risk. I mean, you saw a scrambling defense already, so I think it's just a matter of Jonas Kozlauskas sitting down his guys and putting the most experienced lineup on the court. And that's what I think we're seeing right there. It's Kerpa, Teodosic, Krstic, Šiškauskas, and who is the last guy? Jamal Gordon. So that's a very experience. You're putting Šiškauskas and Krstić back on the floor with Kappa. That's a serious experience, and these guys understand what it takes to bring this game home last 10 minutes.
Olympiacos coach Dusko Ivkovic coached in five different decades from the 70s until now. He's got as much experience as anybody who's coaching today, and he has been using a small lineup. Tesca comes out for the fourth quarter with two of their big guys and some big guards as well. Do you think Duda, you see he's got his small guys back out here again, he's going to have to take that chance, right?
Frank, I think that Duda Ivkovic is looking for anything that would work, because he tried many things and nothing has been working so far. Only now with the run 6-0 at the end of the third quarter, something seemed to be working for Olympiacos.
Olympiacos will inbound the ball and get a chance to knock down this lead. Mansadas up top, working with Hines. Kyle Hines driving on Kirstich, kicks out to Slukas. Slukas from deep, he rattles it in. Kostas Slukas has got it down to a 10-point difference.
And look at that. All of a sudden, it's a 9-0 run by Olympiacos Piraeus.
The defenders are on the floor, but Šiškauskas has the ball. They were trying to double-team and knocked into each other. Shemont Gordon on the wing. He drives to the basket. He's surrounded. Hines blocks him and takes it. Here comes Lucas the other way. Olympiacos trying to get this down to single digits. Into Printezis. He makes his move inside. Keeps it going. Hook shot off the backboard. It's down to 8, Georgina.
What a run by Olympiacos. That was a patented shot by Georgios Printezis. How many times we've seen it right at the top of the season?
Olympiacos has an 11-0 run. CSKA led by as many as 19 in the third quarter. We're early in the fourth. They go inside to Kirstich, and he dances a little too much. Another turnover by CSKA. Here comes the pressure. We hear the Olympiacos fans.
The fans are coming alive, and so is Andrei Kirilenko, who is getting off the bench right there. Zdenek Kirstich, clearly a traveling violation.
Oh, another turnover, and CSKA Moscow's up to 16 turnovers, George. Not like they've taken care of business entirely tonight.
Exactly. I mean, that's a high number of turnovers for such an experienced team. Let's see if this heating up.
Slukas with the ball for Olympiacos. Printezis with a quick shot, misses, and fouls from behind on the rebound. We've seen him make those shots before, but not that time.
But I think he just hesitated a second too long. I mean, he wasn't sure if he was supposed to pass it or shoot it. And that split-second hesitation caused him to miss that shot.
But it's an 8-point game with 8:40 to play in the fourth quarter. So plenty of time for Olympiacos. Teodosic with the ball for CSKA. Gets it to Kirstić, who hands back to swing it to Kliapa. And to Kirilenko, he crosses, goes to the hoop, guarded by Kessel, and there's a foul on the play.
And I believe that's exactly the situation that Jonas Kuzlauskas was talking in the morning before the game. He said, if the game gets on the line, you go with your stars. And right there, there was an isolation play for Andrei Kirilenko against Kessel.
He's got inbounds and swings to Kirilenko again. It goes to Teodosic. Good job of defense by Mansadas. Teodosic still has it. He's driving, but he turns the ball over on a palming violation. Turnover number 17 for CSKA, and another chance for Olympiacos to cut the lead further.
Wow, what a momentum change here in the game, Frank.
George, at what point, at what score difference does the pressure shift very big to CSKA?
Well, I think if you get down to 5, this is a really open game.
Kessel from downtown! We have a 5-point ball game. CSKA 53, Olympiacos with a 14-point run, 14-0, and they're back in this ball game. We have a final. Teodosic from deep, missing, rebound for Šiškauskas. CSKA keeps the ball, but they have the pressure now. Five-point difference.
That was a huge rebound by Ramuna Šiškauskas right there in that possession.
Kliapa out top, guarded by Printezis. Tries to go inside to Kirstić. He misses it. Turnover number 18 for CSKA. And now the pressure mounts.
Frank, I'm not believing what I'm seeing. This is the young kids just completely turning the game around.
Timeout on the floor. It's Olympiacos with a 14-0 run. It started late in the third quarter, but with 7:24 to play, it's anybody's ball game. CSKA 53, Olympiacos 48. And you said it, George. The young guys in a small lineup has befuddled CSKA quite a bit. The defense on the ball by Mansalas is very key here so far. We talked about it. 22-year-old just turned 22, having the defense of a veteran, and he's making it show by stopping Teodosic.
And the first half hero. Frank, just maybe this is the way to pay off Vasilis Panoulis for the whole season. He was carrying Olympiacos the whole season on his back single-handedly. And right now they are making the run without him. So the ball circulation, attitude, absolutely nothing to lose. It's paid off big time for Olympiacos Piraeus.
George, it was 53-34 with 2 minutes left in the third quarter. That means in the last less than 5 minutes, they have cut down 14 points from that difference to make it a whole new ball game, 53-48. Olympiacos came alive, their fans came alive, and as you said, Matheus Manoulis, who is their leader by far, maybe the biggest leader I've seen on any team, led them here, not on the floor, but he can come back now and do what he does.
Well, it's a big question. I mean, do you stay with the same lineup or you put back Vasilis Panoulis? Right now we see the same guys coming out.
No, you stay with the same lineup now, but you know you got him in your pocket towards the last 5 minutes.
I mean, it's 7.5 minutes to go, so there's still a lot of game to be played, Frank. I mean, it's 53-48, and it all started, I don't know if you agree with me, with a little carelessness of CSKA on offense. They're trying to play a little bit too much on individual bases. Would you agree?
And we have 7 minutes and 24 seconds of loud and wild action to get this going. Starts with a foul by Teodosic right away on Mansalas. First foul of the fourth quarter for CSKA. Olympiacos has dosed. We'll keep an eye on the bonus. That's two, so we'll keep an eye on the bonus situation. Mansalas trying to get across half court. On the ball for Olympiacos and another foul on Teodosic. Let's see what the foul situation is in this game so far. We know that for Olympiacos there's a foul trouble. That's number 3 on Teodosic, 3 on Sikowski, 3 on Houston, 4 on Sasha Powell, and 3 on Alexis Shved of CSKA.
So, I mean, I see some frustration on Teodosic's face.
Lucas from 3, he misses. And the rebound to Kirilenko.
That would have been a huge shot if he made that. I mean, he would have brought the house down.
He didn't hesitate at all. These are gutsy young players on Olympiacos. And they're led by Ivkovic, the oldest coach. Here's Teodosic from deep. He misses, the rebound's loose. And that's Lucas who takes it from Kirilenko. Passes ahead to Mansalas, ball's loose and out of bounds on Kessel. That is the risk of playing with young guys and having to come back.
That's exactly right. I mean, they fight their heart out. They put a heart on the line, but sometimes they just make elementary mistakes like that.
Three guys under 23 there playing the fourth quarter of the title game. Three up out top for CSKA. Gets it to Siskauskas. Turn around. Shot on the baseline. Siskauskas settling down. CSKA.
So valuable, Ramuna Siskauskas in the final game. This is the third post-up that he's been able to connect on.
55-48 for CSKA now. Hines moving to the basket, gets it to Printezis with a foul on the pass committed by Griapa. That's his third foul as well, but at this point, really depends who has 4 because everybody's playing.
It doesn't matter. I mean, that was a good foul, and he stopped with that foul and easy basket.
Seems like they're giving the ball to Hines to drive on the bigger men and pass off. It worked for 1 3-pointer. It would have worked on that play if he wasn't fouled. Now it's Mansalas driving baseline all the way across to the corner to Kessel. Off the mark this time, Kessel, and into the hands of Kriapa.
I think right now it's time to bring Vasilis Panoulis back on the court.
With under 6 minutes left, and CSKA up by 7, this has turned around into quite a barn burner. After CSKA was up 19 with 12 minutes of play, they go back to Siskauskas in the post. He is fouled by Slukas,
That's such a difficult matchup right there, because Mahmoudas Shishkauskas is not rushing anything. He's taking his time. He is watching if the double team is coming. If not, thank you very much, guys. I'm going to play one-on-one.
And here comes Vasilis Spanoulis back on the court, as well as Kostas Papanikolaou. So some changes here at the end for Dusan Ivkovic, coach of Olympiacos. And Osic inbounds to Kirstich. Tries to get it back and does. Kirstich loses it on the block by Hines. Here comes Slukas the other way. On the run, Slukas goes inside to Hines. Hines moving inside, spins. Tries to finish, doesn't get it. On the defense by Kirstich.
He is just too small against Kirstich. Kirstich keeps his position, even though he's knocked off a little bit, he still keeps his hands up, and it's extremely difficult for Hines to shoot over him.
But we've seen Hines finish games very strong. His team's now down 7. Liapa on the wing, and a foul off the ball. Looks like it was Vasilis Panoulis running into Ramunas Šiškauskas because he took a shot to the nose or the mouth. See how he is with a foul on that play.
I mean, nobody is saving anything. This is all out war.
There you see, Šiškauskas getting hit by the head of Panoulis, trying to fight through a screen. Now it's Panoulis to see Matsavisa back in the game to replace. Lucas missed by Šiškauskas, rebound by Hines. Very tense moments here as we come up on the 5-minute mark in the fourth quarter. Matsalis to Printezis to Spanoulis to Hines, blocked by Kirilenko. Oh baby,
what a block right there by Kirilenko.
Tadosis to Šiškauskas from the corner, in and out. Matsalis with the ball ahead to Papanikolaou. He doesn't challenge Kirilenko, pulls it out. Printezis to the basket, gets fouled on the way by Kriapa. He'll go to the free throw line. And George, I want to relay the conversation I had with Panoulis after the semifinal. I said, that was unbelievable. And Panoulis said one word, maturity. Here's the block by Kirilenko. Look at that. He just went up. Figure Hines didn't want to try to dunk it because he saw Kirilenko. But wow, what
this
a reaction
out of this world
by Kirilenko from the other side of the basket, getting that block. Printezis on the line, however, has a chance. Drops a free throw. Gets the difference.
That's the lucky roll right there. That's what Olympiacos needed. They missed too many free throws. We've been saying that all game long. Look at that right now, Frank. I mean, all those missed free throws.
Difference down to 6, difference down to 5, 55 to 50. Plenty of time in this game, 4:20 to play. And we have a final. It may be low scoring, but it is a lot of fun here in the Turkish Airlines Euroleague Final 4. Teodosius shadowed by Hines. He walks with the ball. Turnover by Šiška, the pressure mounting. And Olympiacos with a chance to cut the lead to as little as 2 on this possession.
To my taste, Milos Teodosic just got too many mistakes with the travel, with the early fouls. I think this needs to calm down. He's the leader right now in this game. He's the hottest man. He scored 3 pointers in a row in the first half.
Matsalis with the ball for Olympiacos. Goes to Printezis. He's working on Kriapa, turns, shoots, misses, gets his rebound, goes back, puts it down, and it's fouled. A 3-point opportunity for Euroleague's Printezis. It's 55 to 52. And George, see that, a 19-point difference just 8 minutes ago in this game. We have a 3-point ball game and 4 minutes left.
But look at the huge heart of Olympiacos, the way they are fighting. You just see Printezis just staying with his shots, fighting against 3 CSKA guys, huge guys, that is to say. I mean, excellent rebounders and shot blockers, but he stayed with it, he scored, and he's has a chance to make a 3-point play.
What a rebound, and he fouls out Viktor Kriapa, one of the top defenders. Misses the free throw, however, and Kirilenko collects the rebound. Oh, baby.
That was just too much adrenaline. Printezis couldn't calm down for the free throw.
Sped. For Šiška goes into Kirstich. He gets fouled going up. So he will probably go to the free throw. Let's see what the call first. that he will shoot two free throws. Then at Houston, both teams are in the bonus anyway, so every foul from now on puts him on the free throw line.
So free throw shooting, Frank's going to play a huge role down the stretch right now.
And free throw shooting this season, Olympiacos 73.7%. And CSKA 78% as teams, but as we know, Stanulis has been one of the top guys getting to the free throw line. So it depends who's on the court before you talk about team free throw shooting percentage.
I mean, I don't dare to make too many predictions in the game here anymore, Frank. I mean, it's been so unorthodox. If you have CSKA up 19, would you imagine a game like this?
Here's Mitch. Makes the first one with a nice roll for him. George, do you think when Sergio was up 19 with 12 minutes of playing this game, there was any relaxation? I didn't see it personally. They were just playing as hard as can be. They did have some miscues, but I don't think they relaxed.
Hey, they just couldn't close it out, Frank. I mean, I said it started this little carelessness. Carelessness on offense is very dangerous and it's contagious.
5-point lead again for CSKA. 3:30 to play. Spanoulis with the ball goes to Hines. Tries to pass out, it's a turnover. He had two guys to go to, but he was afraid to challenge the shot blockers of CSKA.
He was thinking about that block by Andre Kirilenko. He was looking out for him. Where are you, Andre? I better pass it out.
So CSKA getting stronger after the big 14-point run by Olympiacos. Spread with the ball. Goes to 4-on-7 to Kirilenko. Look at Papa looking out. Challenge here, but Kirilenko puts it down anyway. It's now 59-52. And CSKA coming back on its own.
That was a difficult play there by Andrei Kirilenko. He was able to handle it one-on-one.
Spanoulis on top, working on Spread, gets a screen from Hines, whips it with Matsadis. This is going to be Papanikolaou. 4-3! Dimitris Papanikolaou in the face of Kirilenko.
He is absolutely unconscious. That's unbelievable. Kostas Papanikolaou at 21 years of age.
Unbelievable. 59-55, 2:45 to play. Teodosic for CSKA driving. He's inside. The ball is loose. It goes out of bounds. It is Olympiacos' ball. Unbelievable defense for Olympiacos in this quarter, forcing turnover after turnover after turnover on. And here's the shot again by Papanikolaou. You got one of the best shot blockers in the world right in your face. I'll take that, says the 21-year-old.
That was his second time in a row, just completely covered by Kirilenko.
Spanoulis out top. Goes to Printezis. To Matsadis. Misses the three-pointer from the corner. They were going for the kill there. It's 59-55 still. Coming up on 2 minutes. Teodosic.
A huge defensive possession for Olympiacos.
Teodosic gets it back. Gets a screen from Kirsten, guarded by Hines. Kirilenko driving on Matsadis. Matsadis commits the foul near the basket. He had him until the basket. A smart play by Kirilenko to get to the free throw line.
That's when leaders come to play, Frank. Andrei Kirilenko is the undisputed leader of CSKA team. And here right now in the crunch time, he comes to play. Two crucial plays in a row. Let's see if he can correct on the free throws, though.
He's a 75% free throw shooter this season. Kirilenko is 2-for-2 tonight. And you said, George, those free throws from early in the game might hurt Olympiacos, and they are right now. They've missed 10 free throws tonight, while CSKA is now 10-for-14 on that first one by Kirilenko, opening up that 5-point lead again. He misses the second. The ball is loose, rebounded by Printezis. Gets it to Hines, but still just a 5-point difference, under 2 minutes. Here's Hines bringing the ball all the way up court for Olympiacos. Gets it to Spanoulis. Spanoulis gets it back, 8 on the shot clock. It's a step back 3-pointer, Spanoulis misses. Papanikolaou in there with the rebound, misses the shot, but he'll be going to the free throw line. And before we see the final of this game, George, you have to say a star has been born at this Final Four, Kostas Papanikolaou.
But he's a warrior. Look at it, how active he stays. He gets the monster rebound and just goes back up, right back up. And all the shot blockers and the big players of CSKA. Kristic was there. Kirilenko, he was not afraid. He is not afraid to take the three, take the rebound, just immediately attacking.
George, this is EuroLeague basketball at its finest, and you see the fans of Olympiacos and the fans of CSKA living and dying with every trip down the floor. They are on their feet like they've been all game. For this last 2 minutes, Papanikolaou drops the first free throw, 1:36 to play. He's got his team within four and can make it a one possession game with this free throw. His team's missed 10 before this. Let's see if he can hit two in a row, which I think we've only seen once tonight from Olympiacos.
Really a fascinating game. Unfortunately for Olympiacos, the troubles with free throw shooting continue.
So it's a 4-point game, 60-56, 1:28 to play. Stead with the ball against Spanoulis. Stead, one of the heroes in the semifinal. Looking for a screen, gets it from Kirstich, gets the ball back to Kirstich, hands off to Kirilenko, the ball is loose, tipped by Matsadas, he goes ahead to Spanoulis, inside to Printezis, hook shot, Printezis, it's a two-point ball game with a minute to play!
But look at that, the way they're attacking, it seemed like there was no fast break, and they put it inside, and a quick move by Georgios Printezis, two-point game.
Teodosic with the ball, under a minute left, and by 2 points, CSKA, he has it. Steps back for a jumper, off the mark. Rebound to Printezis. Olympiacos has a chance to tie, down 19, late in the third quarter. It's 40 seconds left. Printezis inside, he's spinning, moving. He's gonna take it, blocked by Voronsevich.
That was a key defensive play, right there.
Printezis wanted it, Voronsevich stuck with him. And made the big block, 25 seconds left. CSKA up two, difference on the shot clock of 10. They're gonna play defense. Foul before the shot, as Teodosic made his move. He will go to the free throw line, foul by Hines.
Frank, did he shoot big free throws against the semifinal game?
He missed two free throws.
Exactly, I mean, this is a carbon copy situation for Milos Teodosic. Is he gonna make the two big ones tonight?
Teodosic has not been to the free throw line so far tonight, but he shoots 84% on the year. So with 19.6 seconds left, what a thriller. They may be defensive games, but they are absolutely thrilling. Teodosic knocks down the first one. He'll take a three-pointer now for Olympiacos to tie. If he makes the second, he really makes it tough on Olympiacos.
This is a crucial free throw.
Teodosic off the mark. Corral the rebound, Papanikolaou. Spanoulis with the ball. 15 seconds left. Sved going after him. The ball to Papanikolaou. He tries to shoot, but he got fouled before the shot by Teodosic.
Smart
trying
play
to prevent a three-pointer with 10 seconds on the clock. Papanikolaou going to the free throw line. What a finish. It's 61-58. 10 seconds and a timeout on the floor. And George, we don't want to harp on Olympiacos, but right now they can't think about all the missed free throws because they're going to have to think about that all season if they don't start making them right now.
I mean, this is a crucial situation. They have only 10 seconds to go. They have two free throws, Frank. They are down 3 points, but I think they will go for two makes and they tried to go for it. Quick foul. I mean, this is coming down to the wire. The best basketball on the continent is played here tonight in Istanbul in Sinan Efes Arena.
Unbelievable final. We had low-scoring semifinals. Very unusual low-scoring final as well. But you can't ask for any more drama than 3 point difference. Somebody on the line with 10.1 seconds left. 19-point comeback. 8 minutes for Olympiacos, meaning they were down 19, got it back to within two. So they have a shot at winning this still with just 10 seconds left.
Frank, it's truly inspirational to see such a young team as Olympiacos go on the floor when the game was seemingly out of their reach and just getting back, just growing inch by inch into the game and just making it here. 3 points, 10 seconds to go. What a game we've had so far, and I don't think it's over yet.
Not at all. 10 seconds is a long time, which is a three-point difference. The 21-year-old Kostas Papanikolaou on the free throw line. The same small lineup out there for Olympiacos and the big guys out there for CSKA. They're going to finish it. Papanikolaou with the first shot. And it goes down. He's got the lead cut to two.
What a final game, what a semifinal, what a final four for Kostas Papanikolaou, Frank.
Couldn't be noisier in most EuroLeague games, but they almost hear a pin drop. Here he is again, Papanikolaou. He makes the second. It's a one-point ball game with 10 seconds to play and a timeout on the floor. And George, it's time to talk strategy.
This is the chess of basketball right here. Two great coaches against each other, Frank.
Let's look at the free throw percentages for the guys that were on the floor. For CSKA, Kirilenko 75%, Kirsten 78%, Teodosic 84%, Siskowska 74%, and Schved 85%. So you got pick your poison if they're going to foul somebody out of those five.
And that's difficult really to say who you foul. I think that Kirsten's going to be out of the question. He's going to clear the court and he's going to run under the basket. So I wouldn't say he would be involved in the inbounding play. But the remaining players that you just named, I don't know. Maybe Alexei Schved, he's the youngest. Maybe his nerves will be unsteady. Yeah, anybody's pick.
Kirstic has a 78% free throw shooting percentage. They got a chance to go for the steal before the foul as well, but they're going to have to make sure they get the foul if they don't get the steal. Let's see what happens with 10.1 seconds left.
And a quick foul too, Frank, because there's only 10 seconds, so they cannot gamble too much, just lose the player completely and not be able to foul him. They need a quick foul.
Zeska will inbound the ball on the near side at half court with Kirilenko taking the ball in, guarded by Printezis. Kirilenko won't be receiving it. You'll see who does receive it. And what if anybody receives it at all? Let's see. Inbounds, 10 seconds left. 61-60. Siskowska ahead and have the ball. The inbounds by Kirilenko. Trying to get it to Siskowska. And he does.
That's a good choice. Ramuna Siskowska has got very strong nerves. He's as experienced as anybody.
Manolis gets caught with a foul. Number four on Spanoulis, and Siskowskis is shooting into the corner, into the end of the arena with all the Olympiacos fans. So if he makes these, he's got a lot of guts. Misses the first one. This means the Olympiacos could go for two or three. There's 9.7 seconds on the clock. Let's see if he makes the second, and who gets the rebound? Siskowskis misses the second. Olympiacos with a chance to win. The ball in the hands of Vasilis Panoulis. Goes by himself, gets it to Printezis. He makes it! Olympiacos ahead! 0.7 seconds left! 0.7 seconds on the clock! Here goes Printezis on the assist by Panoulis. Olympiacos ahead!
This is unbelievable!
61-62.
Unbelievable!
Right to the court. Heinz knocks out of
bounds. The team of destiny.
Olympiacos.
The team of destiny.
Champion.
The team of destiny.
Olympiacos. Well, Printezis. The biggest upset in years in the EuroLeague final. Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
The most unbelievable.
Unbelievable. What a final. Look at them celebrate. Olympiacos. Piraeus. The champions of the EuroLeague. Unbelievable! 19 points down with 12 minutes to play. Olympiacos turned it on, took the title from CSKA Moscow. Let them celebrate. They deserve it. The most unexpected champion of the EuroLeague this century. Olympiacos, Piraeus on the buzzer by Georgios Printezis, assisted by Vasilis Panoulis.
After a complete metamorphosis of the roster, amazing, 10 new players. This team was assembled just during the season even with two additions of two players, and they are winning the finals of the EuroLeague. This is just amazing.
Turkish Airlines, 7 days,
and Winline, official global sponsors in association with the Turkish Airlines Euroleague.
What we are seeing is history in the making. The young players just clawed back inch by inch into the game, and this is incredible. They are claiming the title in Istanbul in a fascinating fashion. Olympiacos Piraeus.
Unbelievable, look at them celebrate. A comeback for the ages, a title that nobody expected. 10 new players on Olympiacos this season, led all the way by Spanoulis. Nobody gave him a chance to make even the playoffs, let alone the Final Four. And here they are winning on the last shot of the entire EuroLeague season. George Zinek, you won with an underdog team in 1999. Žalgiris with the coach of CSKA, Jonas Kasauskas. But I don't think there's ever been quite a title like this one, except perhaps 20 years ago this weekend in Istanbul when Partizan won on the last shot as well.
I have never seen anything like it or been associated with this. Was so inspirational. If you have a young team like that coming back from 19 points down, I have nothing to say.
I think we should hold the Final Four in Istanbul every year. 20 years ago, the last one, Partizan Belgrade winning with a shot by Saša Đorđević in the same manner. And now it is Georgios Printezis repeating history in Istanbul with the most unexpected champion probably in that 20-year span, Olympiacos Piraeus. We will come back for the trophy ceremony after we show you our player of the game video about none other than Kostas Papanikolaou. Here is how he became the player of the game. Kostas Papanikolaou, head-to-head with Andrei Kirilenko, came in and started playing strong. His team struggled a lot. He got some easy points early in the game, but he is a 21-year-old. Look at that dunk he had in the first half. He just kept charging hard, and even when his team was down 19 with 12 minutes to play, he came up with this huge three-pointer right in the face of the MVP, made another and another. Kostas Papanikolaou, 18 points, 4 rebounds, 3 for 3 from downtown, and 1 steal. He is the player of the game. Let's talk to Kostas Papanikolaou right now.
Incredible game, 18 points, 4 rebounds. How does it feel?
I cannot realize what really happened right now. I can. We was 13 points back, 1 minute to the third quarter, but we say we gotta put our soul inside the game, give everything. It's the last 10 minutes, and the end of the clock says 61-62 Olympiacos. I cannot say nothing more.
We were amazed watching you play. We think a star has been born. Papanikolaou, you were incredible. What was the key moment for you?
This team, these guys, is my family. They give me strength, they give me energy, they give me everything. Okay, I scored the first shot, then I got confidence, and everything was easier for me after that. But all the credit should go to all this team, to all these fans that they are here tonight and helping us, supporting us. I cannot just say about myself. We bring the team all together here. We won this game all together.
Kostas, we're talking about your offense, but you did a great job on defense. You held Andrei Kirilenko, you got in front of him, took a charge. What is it like going against such a great player like Andrei Kirilenko?
It's very tough to guard him, I can say, because he's a great off-ball cutter, he's a great offensive rebounder. It needs 40 minutes full concentration on him, because even if you forgot yourself for 1 second, he will cut, he will do something, you're going to lose him, and you're going to create something for his team. I tried to be concentrated on him, And thanks God I helped my team as much as I could.
Did you ever dream that this could happen? Olympiacos champions of the EuroLeague?
The truth is that I have very confidence on this team from the first day, but I never dreamed of something like this. This is the truth, I have to say the truth.
Enjoy it. You deserve it. You guys had an incredible season. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
A star is born. Kostas Papanikolaou leading Olympiacos to the most amazing comeback title, perhaps in European basketball history. Let's now see what was our play of the game in this unbelievable final in Istanbul. And here it is, it had to be. 10 seconds left, Spanoulis makes his move. Goes to Printezis, the quick shot that put them ahead for the first time since the early moments of the game. And that is the only time they had to be ahead. Georgios Printezis with his patented one-hander, very quick, over the CSKA defense to win the EuroLeague title, 61-62. And the Sinan Erdem Arena in Istanbul is rocking. George, take over, my voice is giving way.
I mean, if you look at this is a Cinderella story. This is an incredible story of a team that was on the brink of elimination even in the regular season. Then they went down to the last game against Galatasaray Istanbul in top 16. Then they went on to playoffs against Siena. They disposed of them very easily. Came here, Frank, and they clawed and fought a big battle in the semifinal, just to play the most incredible final of any competition I have seen in my life.
First title for Olympiacos since 1997. First title for head coach Dusko Ivkovic since 1997. But could not have been more unexpected, even by them. I asked somebody in the Olympiacos camp yesterday, I said, did anybody expect this to be in the final? And can anybody really say they expected this during the season? And the guy said to me, I'm every day with Vasilis Panoulis, so that's my answer.
He is the ultimate warrior, the leader of the team, Frank, and I honestly believe this was the payback for his leadership during the whole season.
We are going to take a look at the trophy ceremony as soon as we can hear some voice. 68-and-a-half-year-old Duda Ivkovic becomes the oldest EuroLeague champion as a head coach, or as a player for that matter. He's one of the D's. We said he started coaching in the 70s, George, five different decades. He's been a head coach in Europe and has won every major title in European basketball. And now he has his second EuroLeague title, thanks in part to a group of 21-year-olds who he was like a grandfather to this season.
I mean, they just came on the court and played their guts out without any respect or fear of the situation. They were in a deep hole, but they just managed. But who else do you manage it with but the young kids?
Look at this, an unbelievable, unbelievable final game. In the early going, it was all defense. The first quarter barely had any points. It was 10-7, 24-13. CSKA took off in the second quarter, and by the end of the third, we're up 19. And now the other team is celebrating, Olympiacos Piraeus, with the most incredible comeback in European basketball history.
Look at that.
Look at the winning,
right,
game-winning shot. But think of Spanoulis with the ball and the clock, 10 seconds to win the title. Presence of mind to dish to the open second scorer on the team.
That's the greatness of a player. And Duda Ivkovic said, this player can say, I mean, can distinguish when to pass and when to shoot.
And we see the very disappointed Andrei Kirilenko and the rest of his team. They played a fantastic season. We have got to give them all the credit they could possibly deserve for taking it all the way down to the last second. But they got ambushed by the same team that ambushed a lot of others and played every second to the finish to win this game. Olympiacos Piraeus.
Frank, truly, I think if you want to give a name to a team, if you want to say a team of destiny, this is it, Olympiacos Piraeus. This is my candidate for the ultimate team of destiny.
It is no exaggeration at all, George, to say that nobody on Olympiacos would have been talking about a title this season until perhaps they walked in the playoffs. And that's when we heard Duda Ivkovic say, at one point in the top 16, the middle round, he said, after game two of the middle round, he said, I don't think this team can make it to the playoffs. It would be a miracle.
He's like, it would be.
But then he walked into the playoffs when they made it and said, I think we're the favorites.
Exactly. I mean, he was really doing a great job of taking the pressure off his young team. And what I love about what he said is that we have a lot of players. We have players from Europe, we have Greeks, we have Americans, but they all go into one direction, Frank. This is a very strong statement. He said this is a unique team, and he's been coaching many teams.
George, you've been in basketball for a long time. I've been following basketball for more than 30 years. I don't think I've ever seen a team go from small to unbelievably large over the course of a season as this Olympiacos team has done. And it was really, this game was a microcosm of their season. Fighting hard, but not enough in the first quarter. And there's the announcement of the MVP, Vasilis Panoulis. Who else receiving the MVP trophy from Turkish Airlines EuroLeague President Hamdi Topçu, the sponsor of the competition, giving the trophy of the MVP to the Final Four. Second time that Vasilis Panoulis has won this. First time was with Panathinaikos. He becomes, of course, the first EuroLeague champion to play for the two biggest Greek teams. He's got tears in his eyes. Vasilis Panoulis was a father for the second time just a couple months ago, and he has been, the heart and soul is saying too little for what he has been for this team. Joey Dorsey told me when he got there in the top 16, he was there for three games, and Vasilis Panoulis said to him, "Don't worry, Joey, you're going to take us to the Final Four." That's the kind of confidence he gave to a guy who just walked on the team in the middle of the season, and he just gave it to everybody, all the young guys, all the newcomers, and led this team. That is why he's the MVP of the Final Four, as we see Olympiacos get their trophies one by one. Player of the game tonight, Kostas Papanikolaou. What a effort by him. Peto Antic, 29 years old, in his first Final Four, he couldn't have been happier just getting into Istanbul. He's walking away a champion with the net around his neck.
What you said, Frank, I mean, Vasilis Panoulis just never, this is the little big man, Kyle Hines. How much respect do you have for him? I mean, so many big guys he's outplayed, he went against, and he never backed down.
We saw Vangelis Mantzadas, who's played defense like a veteran, another 22-year-old. There's Marco Kessel, yet another young guy. AC Law
playing injured today.
Season.
Playing injured, Frank, don't forget that.
Gave some minutes. There's Printezis. He made the shot that won it all. Panagiotis Vasilopoulos, injured for the last little while. He's been around trying for this for a long time. Kostas Sloukas gets his trophy too, another 22-year-old. Joey Dorsey raising the cup. I'm sorry, two guys from Panathinaikos and Olympiacos, but this man, Lazaros Papadopoulos, now wins his second trophy as well. And that, it looks like Duda Ivkovic maybe can't believe it. He said after the semifinal, what a surprise the way his team controlled Barcelona. This, entirely different kind of game. They made the biggest comeback in European history. And look at the man, 68 and a half year old, Dusan Ivkovic, the Dean of European Coaching, leads a group of strangers and kids to the most amazing EuroLeague title in recent memory.
Incredibly inspirational story, what Duda Ivkovic has done during the season, the way he gave confidence to his players, incredible. All of the players,
unbelievable story, Duda Ivkovic returning this season to Olympiacos after many years away, becomes coached them to the first title in 1997, and is now, there's Milan Tomic, who won in 1997, and is now an assistant coach, Christos Stavropoulos, one of the executives of Olympiacos, who's been there all along,
ladies,
getting his trophy as well. Just a lot of people who've worked a long time and had the
Turkish
faith
Airlines
and got this team
EuroLeague
in the last
champions.
Second of the EuroLeague season, a championship
Olympiacos
that no one but no one expected. There they are, raising the trophies on the podium. Olympiacos, Piraeus going home to the port city of Piraeus, Greece, with the most unexpected trophy in EuroLeague history. EuroLeague Basketball President CEO Jordi Bertomeu carrying it out, giving it to a trio of veterans on that team, Vasilopoulos, Panoulis, and Printezis. There it goes, into the air. The champions of the 2011-2012 EuroLeague, Olympiacos,
Piraeus, they are the champions.
They are deservingly the champions. Amazing stories written to the history of EuroLeague. Look at that. That's a celebration in Piraeus, Greece tonight, all night, Frank.
They are gonna love it down in Greece. They are gonna love it. They love it here in Sinan Erdem Arena in Istanbul, Turkey. They put on a fantastic organization to make this an incredible final four, a one-point final, a four-point semifinal, and a two-point semifinal. It has to be also the closest final four in history. And there you see the result, a one-point win by Olympiacos Piraeus, beating heavily favored CSKA Moscow after coming back from 19 points down with 12 minutes to play.
So that's a 20-point turnaround against CSKA Moscow, who was completely in control.
20-point turnaround after CSKA had held them to just 40 points in the first three quarters. Unbelievable. There's no other word for it. This is a dream come true for Olympiacos Piraeus. They believe, whether or not on paper anything was logical about winning this title, this is about faith, this is about leadership, and this is about a team believing in its coach and all its leaders and taking the EuroLeague title on the season's last second.
It just really showed it how much effort and heart you put out on the court. That's what really counts in a Final Four format where only 40 minutes decide if you do or die, if you advance or you go home. This is what happens. Effort, extra effort. And at the end, the momentum changed and Olympiacos just wanted it more.
We're trying to get a chance to talk with Coach Dusko Ivkovic, but you see him at the top of the podium right there, celebrating as he should and as he deserves to. He wants to hold that trophy. Give it to him. Dusko Ivkovic on the top of the podium, and there he gets it. Dusko Ivkovic waiting for a chance to lift the trophy. And there it goes, the man. What a change of game he devised by bringing in a small lineup and just totally befuddling the CSKA, which they were so confident, so in control, CSKA Moscow. Much bigger, much more powerful, but little by little, a 19-point lead dwindled. And in the final minute, they were able to get it down to two. Big missed free throws by Teodosic gave them the chance not only to tie.
And look at that, I mean, there was nothing to, I think there was not much left, and I think Dusko Ivkovic was just trying things to find anything to get back into the game and just played off two quick threes, one at the end of the third quarter, and opened up the fourth quarter. We had a 10-point game, and all of a sudden, just momentum just completely swung in the favor of Olympiacos Frank. Let's not forget that Olympiacos Piraeus missed 11 free throws, 11 free throws.
And still won this game. We've got Johnny Rogers down on the floor. We're hoping he gets a chance to talk to Dusko Ivkovic. We shall see in a minute, but right now they're cutting the nets. Look at the fans from Olympiacos in their whole corner of the stadium, just ready to party. They're rewarded for all their faith and belief in this team. And Spanoulis raising the trophy to them. What a scene here at Sinan Erdem Arena in Istanbul, Turkey. I don't think I've seen anything like this before in basketball, George.
This is really a special moment, and I know Johnny was a tough player in his days, but I don't think he's got it in him to wrestle away Dusko Ivkovic from that crowd, Frank. I think we're gonna have to wait some more.
Let's remind everybody that 20 years ago on the same weekend, the Final Four weekend, Partizan Belgrade in Istanbul had probably the next biggest shot, closest to the buzzer, to win the title. Another totally unexpected team. Twice in Istanbul, two completely surprised champions, and two last seconds shots. There's something about this city that makes it a incredible, exciting title game.
I mean, if you go back and you replay the Sasha Georgievich shot, that was amazing, and this one is right up the alley. And then, Frank, they say that the history doesn't repeat itself.
And we think we might have a shot at talking to Dusko Ivkovic, the 68-year-old head coach of champion EuroLeague, new EuroLeague champion, new EuroLeague champion, Olympiacos. Let's hear what he has to say. Just 1 second. Johnny Rogers and Duda Ivkovic.
Ivkovic, just an incredible storybook season. You guys are European champions. You did an incredible job. When did you believe it was possible?
Look, now, I think this moment is so high emotion. It's very difficult to speak. Even nobody here of players committee, even the fans, cannot believe it. Now, what we done, let's say, in last four or five months, you remember our first game with Bilbao, low level of the basket until the highest level. We did a great job. I want to congratulate to all players, to all my staff, and for sure the main thing what we did is we brought the fans back. You saw that half of court was white and red, and this moment I'll deducted this victory to the fans.
It's an incredible story that 15 years ago you won the EuroLeague in Rome, but with a team that dominated. This year you have a young team, I've changed so many players. You did an incredible job coaching. I want to give you congratulations, but it was just an incredible job. It was our pleasure to watch you.
Thank you, Johnny. Look now, it is some history, I say always. Yes, I was lucky with this generation of players. I want to congratulate them. Very short time, the growth is so much. But like it was before 15, or before 30, or 40, it means and for myself that I work hard together with my players.
I'm so happy for you, coach. Enjoy, enjoy it. You deserve it. All the way.
There we heard from Dusan Ivkovic, the amazing coach of Olympiacos Piraeus, a miracle season, a miracle finish, a miracle title that he dedicates to the fans. There was the game-winning shot by Georgios Printezis with less than a second to go. And the swat away by Kyle Hines to finish it. And the celebration, never before has a team so unexpectedly come and taken the EuroLeague title in such dramatic fashion as tonight. You saw Olympiacos Piraeus claim their second EuroLeague title, coming back from 19 points behind with 12 minutes to play to shock CSKA Moscow, to shock the basketball world with an incredible title to finish an incredible 2012 Turkish Airlines Final Four. George Zidek, we're watching the replays. We want to thank you. Thank our fans for joining us. You know now what EuroLeague basketball is all about. Next year, it's London, England for the Final Four, and it could be better than this because it just gets better every year.
Frank, it's been a pleasure. It's been incredible, and I'm just so happy that I've been associated with EuroLeague this season. I want to thank everybody.
We'll say goodbye from Istanbul, Turkey, till the next EuroLeague season. Olympiacos, the champions.
EuroLeague.
Emotion.
Turkish Airlines Euroleague.
I feel devotion.
Presented by Turkish Airlines, Nike, and Intersport.